tell you differently. I'm live.
Okay, there we go. We're good.
I can see the things moving. We totally have sounds.
And boom. We're live.
Are we now?
We're live with...
Adrian.
Yes.
My name's Adrian.
I was going to say the tick, but also Adrian.
Yeah. Well, we also have our spoon.
Yeah, the spoon is here.
Oh, my God. It yells Pikachu when you eat with it. Oh, my God. It's the best.
So this is the tick on SNES. There are three different ways, technically four different ways, that people could be exposed to the tick in their lifetime that I'm aware of.
Well, right? they've got the comic.
We got the comic.
They've got the cartoon.
We got the cartoon.
You've got the first and second live action.
Yep, and that's all.
That's it, that's four.
That's the four. Boom, got it, nailed it.
Oh, well, the game, and then the game, and then apparently there's a board game.
Board game, so six ways. What are the odds of the board game is someone's first exposure to the tick?
It was my first exposure.
Okay, well, there you go.
Highly likely, apparently.
One.
Yeah, at least
one.
One in three.
One in three. These are odds.
I'm going to get to it here. We're going to start the game with the Knight of a Million Zillion Ninjas.
Wow. Where's her pants? Like, her pants aren't where they need to
that's
be.
That's a good question.
And they're everywhere else.
Completely covered in all,
in all the wrong places, yeah.
You make a good point there. So, the title of this chapter is very accurate. We are about to punch... a lot of fucking ninjas.
Oh, man.
Yeah, so the way this game is structured, as I remember it, is you're basically fighting the henchmen of the boss you're trying to, like, catch up to.
Okay.
And so there'll be, like, three chapters where you're fighting their hench people all the way there. And so for the next three chapters, we are going to punch a lot of fucking ninjas.
You know, I don't know why they didn't make this a two-player game, considering it's a beat-em-up.
It doesn't make any sense that it's not a two-player
game.
Don't
jump off the bus, though. Yeah, but this is a wide-ass bus.
Whoops! Okay, so I've summoned Arthur. We don't need to summon Arthur yet. But yeah, so we got a couple of different combos we can do here. So
I like how tall he is.
Yeah, oh yeah, he's so much bigger than most of the other enemies. Oh, God.
Like in real life.
Yeah.
Well, real tick life.
Real tick life. Okay. I definitely remember being able to do different finishers here, and I am not succeeding at it
so
right now.
So Trev had this growing up.
Oh,
well,
man.
You
yeah.
rented this,
I
right?
I rented the shit out of it. It's one of those games that I rented, like, over and over and over again for some reason.
That was Jackie Chan for me.
Yeah. But yeah, there's, like, a way to, like, pick a guy up and, like, slap him around. There's a way to...
Do you need to progress forward, or are they just going to keep on
they
coming?
They keep coming.
Until,
they okay. keep coming. So we're on this bus until I beat all of them.
Oh, okay, you flicked him.
We got the flick there.
Okay, nice.
There we go. We got the flick. So the flick is you...
He's so pog.
It's so good. Okay, level
Wow,
done.
Is that the... What? Wow.
Okay, so now in order to get to the next stage, we have to run across these rooftops. So the way that this works is if
You're not even running.
Yeah, you kind of... We kind of just kind of, oh God, okay. Yeah, so the way this part works is if you fall in one of these holes, you actually don't take damage and die. Instead, you have to fight one of the many, like, tick enemies that's, like, part of the canon. So you fall down there, you got to fight a boss to get back up, basically. But I might
feel
just
like
die
you're doing
to...
a shitty job dodging.
I might just die to all this shit instead. That's
you didn't
be a
make the jump.
Yeah, so now I'm going to have to fight somebody. So I have to fight the...
a subplot.
I got to fight, yes, the subplot. So I got to fight the speed kid now. And
oh,
I'm
the runner, the jogger,
yeah,
the shoe.
Yeah.
I don't know what he's called.
And I'm probably going to die. Oh, no, I get my health back. We got a chance here. Oh, my God. Okay, we're fine. Oh, my God.
This is a very kind game.
There we go. Okay, well, we got one kick in there.
Oh, yeah, yes, forgiving. It's
forgiving.
A forgiving
yeah,
game,
yeah.
yeah.
It's debatable on whether this is better than if I just took damage and
now,
got
now,
back
what,
up.
Once you do this, do you have to continue running?
Yeah, you get teleported back up to the roof, and then you
Dude,
have to
Dude, he
keep
is
running.
Fucking owning you.
Yeah, it's a real problem.
Like, it really says something of somebody's superpower, and I'm going to make fun of, you know, people who just run really fast as their superpower, but...
Like the Flash. And
that's
the
his name.
Yeah.
Like, bro, I'm fast.
And I'm dead. No. Oh, I'm live. Wait. Oh, right. Because it just kind of picks
right
back up. Because
we've got lines. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, okay. That's going to make it a little complicated for us to transfer.
We'll figure it out. Yeah, we'll figure it out.
Oh, my God. I'm getting smoked here.
I mean, it makes no difference, right? It makes no difference.
Oh, man.
Dude, come on. Come on. Come on.
Just burning through some lives here.
Can you summon Arthur?
I can summon Arthur.
But what is he going to do?
Oh, I can't summon Arthur here, actually. Okay, I can do this.
Dude, you're going to die. You're going to die. Where's his health, though?
We don't see his health bar. I just got to hit him X number of times. Okay, I've gone through two lives now on Speed Kid here.
And you can't keep on punching him when he's...
So I believe after one hit, he can't be hurt anymore. We're going to find out.
I wish that was like that for us.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Well,
yeah,
we kind of do get it, because when you're on the ground...
Wow.
Well, I feel like you just lifted up your foot and just clotheslined himself.
Boom. Problem solved. Okay, so now we're going to
Cheap and nasty. I will never stay at a hotel with this called Cheap and Nasty.
The Cheap and Nasty Hotel.
Sorry, the Cheap and Nasty.
Cheap and... Oh, God.
Nasty.
Oh, man. Yeah, these stages I remember being a really big problem. Okay, we made it. I was almost there when I fell in
the
hole.
Yeah, the pits.
The pits.
Also a hotel I will not stay at.
The pits, Cheap and Nasty. Not great. Okay. Let's see if I can remember how to do our other finishers here.
Oh, that was an uppercut.
Yeah, yeah. We got the uppercut. Uppercut I think we get just by mashing it out. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And then the flick you get by pressing forward for the last hit.
I feel like these combos aren't very difficult.
I'm trying to remember. There's a great one that I am just not succeeding at getting here. Okay, well, let's try it on this guy. Nope. But yeah, you know, this is the tick experience. It's mostly just a lot of punching ninjas, at least for now.
I mean, if you've watched the shows and whatnot, this is really all that it is. He's just going around doing bullshit the whole time.
It's true. Tell me everything you know about the tick, Adrian.
Not much.
Okay.
Not much. I just like to watch it.
Okay.
I think it's ridiculous. Okay. Like so my first experience with the tick was the cartoon, but I don't really remember much of it. But I did watch all of the original
the show.
Show, right? Live action show.
The one with Patrick Warburton as the tick.
Yeah. Because the voice is just so... His face, he never opens his eyes.
You don't need to have open eyes when you're the tick.
No, and I just like his antennae did his thing. Yeah. Like, it was just so good.
Yeah, Patrick Warburton, definitely good casting for the tick. But that show, unfortunately, did not take off.
Even the new guy that new live action one, he was good in his own way.
Good. Yeah, he's very good, too.
And you know, but... I watched the crap out of that, and my favorite was Batmanwell.
Batmanwell.
Oh my god! And then his little shitty car. And oh my god! Yeah, no, it was just good. You missed a flick. How do you miss a flick?
I did. I missed the flick.
We got the roundhouse. I would read the comic books.
Okay.
Of the tick, if I could ever. You know, care to. Get them.
That makes sense. I've never read the comic books before, but I do know that the creator of the tick actually started not as a comic, but as a newsletter that was sent out to all comic like stores in the Boston area. So like he was working for a comic shop and he started this newsletter to like announce upcoming events and like releases and stuff.
Oh shit, yeah.
And the tick was his little mascot character on the newsletter that he would send out.
Oh fuck, that's brilliant. That's brilliant.
And then eventually...
What the fuck just happened?
I don't know. But yeah, eventually he spawned that off into like its own character, turned it into its own comic, and then everything kind of spiraled from there.
So Broski had a comic book store.
He worked for one. I don't think he owned it, but he was like he was a worker there, and he started doing a newsletter for other stores in the area to kind of like let everyone know what was happening in town. And yeah, the Tick was his.
That's crazy. You just go from a dude working at a comic book store.
To the Tick.
Yeah.
So there is another popular show that he created as well, and it might be more fun if I try to make you guess it.
Oh no! God no! We're going to be here for fucking ever.
What if I told you it's an animated series that is also a spoof of another popular series of shows?
Or that does not help series. Me out no, it does one not. Bit.
Doesn't yeah. doesn't work. Okay.
No.
It was an Adult Swim show. Is that
does not. Down? No. God
okay.
no.
Okay.
Was it Aqua? Wait, no. The one.
Nope. Okay. Oh my God! I'm just burning through lives. Okay. After the start of the next stage, you're taking over because I've lost three lives here.
That's all right. It's all right. Okay. I believe in you, Trevor.
Uh huh. Man, I cannot remember how to do the other enders here.
Sometimes you don't need to know. You just do.
just mash it out. Yeah. The name of the show is The Venture Brothers.
Don't know that.
Really?
No.
Never seen The Venture Brothers.
Okay. No.
It was a spoof of Johnny Quest. Are you familiar with Johnny Quest?
No.
Okay.
I know Johnny Bravo, but not Johnny Quest.
Hey, ha.
Oh my God, so good. So good.
Man, I'm pretty. That's the best I got. All right, well, you know, I guess I could just keep doing the flick here. We know how to do the flick.
Does it do any more damage than the uppercut, though?
It gets me a little bit more range, I think. And also, it's just looks good.
Hmm. you can't argue with that. It just looks good.
But yeah, there's a way I can, like, pick a dude up.
Have you tried down?
I've been trying a lot of the different directions, and they're not really working out the way they're supposed to.
Gavin, you did hear Johnny Bravo.
Oh, yeah, Johnny Bravo.
Yeah, we were just talking because he was mentioning some dude called Johnny Quest.
Yes, Johnny Quest. Okay, I'm gonna figure this out eventually here. But yeah, as you can see, we're still punching ninjas. If you're just joining us, ninjas are still getting punched here. It's a million, night of a million ninjas.
Gavin's dad watched Johnny Quest.
Yes, it is. So Johnny Quest is one of those shows that has like three different versions because it started in like the 80s. There was a 60s version. There was
it
like
was on eight, the 60s, yeah.
Yeah, it was a 60s one, an 80s one, and then there was like a like mid-2000s one that was like a reboot as well. So there's a lot of different versions of Johnny Quest out there.
Wow.
All right.
There was just one guy there. That to... All right, what are the buttons?
Chapter 2, Thorn of Oblivion. So A is your punch. Y is your kick.
Why are they so far apart?
I hate it.
I don't
know. I don't know why. This game actually was... So I practiced a little bit of this game on the... you got to run across the rooftops here. There's your jump. I practiced a little bit of this game on the arcade cabinet downstairs. Before today, and it was much easier to do the like combo enders on the arcade cabinet than it was on the actual SNES, and I don't know why. I guess.
Oh man, we're just meat shielding them like you were meat shielding them.
Okay, two buttons in a direction.
A direction.
Well, so it's AA forward A for the flick.
Can I jump back up on the
AA
top?
Back A, AA down A.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna fucking die.
Yeah, that might happen, but you know you're gonna be fine.
We'll
there you go.
It's the Superman clone.
Clark is the caped wonder.
Clone. Yeah.
It's so good. Okay, so this fight is actually one of the easier ones. If you try to take him on toe-to-toe, he is going to kick your ass, but...
Is there any other way to do this, though?
You can find Kryptonite in this stage somewhere, and then hold it up in front of him. There it is. Yeah, and so now he's really weak, and he should go down really easy. Yep, there you go.
Wow! Wow! Holy shit! Okay.
Kryptonite makes that fight
way easier.
Yeah, I think so.
And they didn't really try to hide it, either. It was just like, what's this shiny green thing on the floor?
Just kind of right there. So, jeez. Yeah, so of all of the... You're fine, you're fine. Cool. Of all the bosses you can fight down there, I think that's the best one to get. I think the worst one is the Chainsaw Vigilante. You can get him down there, and he is hard as hell to beat.
I like the name.
Chainsaw Vigilante is
I feel
a solid
like
name.
Falling down will mm-hmm. save you from losing a life.
I hadn't thought of that, but you're right, because it gives you full health.
It gives
you
full
drop,
health, and
yeah.
if you get him,
mm-hmm.
you know, it... oh,
you made
whoa.
It. Just barely. Look at
fuck.
That.
Fuck. So I take it X will summon Arthur?
Yes, X summons Arthur.
Oh, but the bumpers.
I don't know if the bumpers do anything. Oh, you're tightrope walking. Look at this.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Oh, this is exactly the same type of level we just fucking
my
played.
God, this is awful.
Can I just go down? No.
Nope. You got a tightrope walk. Oh, this is
oh,
a
man.
Nightmare.
This is terrible. Why do you give me bullshit stages, Trevor? I don't even know what.
This is crazy.
Can I duck?
You can duck.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't fucking matter.
Oh my god.
One more hit and I'm dead.
What a fucking
disaster. We're good.
I do have to wait.
No. Oh, bullshit.
Right there.
Bullshit.
That was the end of the stage. I do love the way he does the little, like, ballerina toe
twirl
when he jumps.
Pirouette.
The pirouette, yeah. Doo-doo-doo. So I also found out that the creator of The Tick, whose name is Ben Eldmond, I believe it is.
Oh, come on, let me punch you. Thank you.
I found out that he also apparently wrote for the Star Wars The Clone Wars show.
No shit.
Yeah. A long career that is more than just The Tick. Mmm. You got the flick down. Da-da-da-da-da.
Let me kick you.
There you go. So yeah, you can do multiple kicks and you end with a roundhouse. I think there's like a kick, punch, punch, kick combo. I think. Gavin says the first live action Tick show is free on Tubi.
Oh, yeah, but they have ads. Nobody likes ads.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of the Amazon one, which I believe is included with Prime.
It is included.
Yeah, because it was an Amazon original.
Yes. And when that became a no-go, mm-hmm. They had an auction.
Oh, good.
And I wanted to bid on the suit so fucking badly.
How much was the suit?
Last time I checked, it was a few grand. Mm. Like, yeah, that's a lot of money. But is it really? Like, I would have to buy a mannequin.
It would be your Halloween costume for life.
It would just be my mm-hmm. my clothes. Adrian, what are you wearing today? The Tick costume. Like it would be leather. I could wear it on my motorcycle. It would look cool.
That's a good point.
God, but he was taller than me.
Mm. Yeah,
because the dude's a monster. Like
he's a pretty tall guy.
Yeah, isn't he like 6'3" or some shit?
Yeah, so the suit would probably kind of collapse on you. You know?
Yeah. Like I would have to get it tailored. Could you imagine walking somewhere? It's like I need this tailored.
What do you think, love? Can you tailor a
well,
a
it's
suit,
leather,
a
so
suit?
The machine you would have to have like.
Yeah.
You do? Well, that's cool.
The Tick costume is... It's not
real leather. No, it's not real leather, no. It's like it's spandexy. Not spandexy, it's like...
That
rubbery shit.
The scuba fabric.
Oh, I have no idea what the scuba fabric's called.
I'm saying it loud, and I hope you all remember what it's called.
Oh, okay. There's a guy.
It's essentially a scuba net. But yeah, you shape that over... Foam.
Ooh, double flick.
You essentially have to carve the foam into the shape of the abs.
So, yeah, I was about to say, if it came with pre-muscles, I should, it would be all right. I mean, pre-muscle,
yeah.
like
pre-sculpted.
Look, man, I've been working out for almost 2 years, and there's no sculpturing under this shirt, my dude.
Okay, so now you have a friend. It's Oedipus.
Her kick is my punch.
Yeah.
God, that's fucked up.
Have fun with that. But yeah, so she's gonna hang out and help fight stuff with you now.
Yeah, we'll just keep him on her side so I don't get hit.
Yeah, exactly. Da, da, da,
da, da, da. Oh, that is bullshit!
Oh, denied! Oh my god. The first line, oh yeah, we already saw that one. Okay, yeah, no, she's I feel like I got the better end of the deal with Paul the Samurai.
I like it how his name is just Paul.
Paul. Yeah, good old Paul. You know, doing the samurai things. And now she leaves. Yeah, they kind of stick with you just until you finish, like, the current area that you're on. Now you gotta fight more ninjas.
Of course. Yeah, Why wouldn't we fight more ninjas?
So I believe the next chapter, we are done with ninjas. Which is to say...
We're never done with ninjas.
Which is to say, the next chapter, we will still fight ninjas, but it'll be the last chapter where we fight ninjas.
I really feel like there's nothing to this game. We haven't even gotten told a story yet.
No.
Like, this is an Adrian-style game right here.
This game doesn't give a fuck. This game doesn't give a fuck.
Jesus.
It's exactly what you were talking about before. Let me just, like, go. This game's Yeah. Just fucking look.
Let me punch shit.
Yeah, this game goes, there's ninjas. Go punch them. And that's it. That is the story right now. There are ninjas. They're in our way.
So I had a D&D character that I based off the tick. I called him Guy.
Good.
And you're not fucking getting me, Guy. Yeah, he took himself out.
He did.
So I called him Guy. Okay. Guy LeBug.
Guy LeBug.
Because he was a tick, you know? And
It's good.
I did hand-to-hand combat was okay. My jam.
Okay.
But then what did I have? I had something where I could just use anything as a weapon, you know? So I'll just pick up rocks and throw rocks at people. And it was, because, you know, you can find rocks everywhere.
Improvised fighting, I think it's called.
But oh man, he was my favorite. My fucking favorite. Because like I'm running on the rooftops because I didn't run on the streets. Because would you?
Yeah, no.
So I'm running, and I'm like, I want to throw a stone, and they're like, you're on the roof. I'm like, then let's rip off these fucking shingles, you know? So the town that we were in had so...
There it
what
is.
Did I just do?
You got one. See, you picked him up, you slapped him around, perfect.
Yes.
You got it. You figured one out. So what are you doing to make that happen?
I'm pushing up in the direction that they're facing.
Okay.
Well, that's what I was doing. Now, apparently, it's not working anymore. But there it is.
There he goes. Yeah,
and you're invincible when it happens?
You are,
Fuck yes.
Yeah, so there's two grab throws. That's one of them. And then there's another one where you, like, grab their leg and just, like, bash.
Yeah! There we go!
That's it.
Well.
So, yeah, during those two moves, you are invincible.
Yeah, no, the combos were easy. It's either up towards them or down towards them.
Okay. So I think I probably was not angling it towards them enough.
Well, you've got four directional buttons here. It's really not that hard.
Yeah. Gavin says Chairface Chippendale is the goat, which is true.
How does he eat?
We don't worry about those things.
We need to worry about these things.
Nope,
you're not kidding me.
What the fuck's going on with that guy? So there was another cartoon that was kind of a spoof of superheroes. Nice. That I used to enjoy watching a lot. Part of me wants to try and make this a guessing game again.
No, we've established that I don't know this shit. God, I never know this shit.
Are you familiar with Freakazoid?
Oh my God, I fucking love Freakazoid! Oh my God, yes.
Yeah, to me, the tick and Freakazoid...
Oh my God,
They occupy a similar space in my brain. They're
dude,
kind of
oh
very
my...
kin shows,
so
you know?
when Columbine happened... Mm. My school, when Centennial, like, everybody needs a school ID and they need to carry it on them, which were bullshit. And I would lose mine every day. And so it was a five or $10 replacement fee. So I decided to make my own.
Okay.
And then I'm like, fuck it, I don't need to put my name on this. So I had a Freakazoid one. And
Freakazoid.
Oh, yes. So my name was Freakazoid Super Freak.
Freakazoid Super Freak. That's pretty good.
Oh, dude, I fucking loved it.
Oh, man.
Oh, dude, it was... Yeah.
I
dude,
love
Freakazoid is so good.
Yeah, I really love Freakazoid. Oh. One of my all-time favorites is I remember...
Poogas!
Poogas, yep. One of my all-time favorites is there's an episode where this guy makes this, like, weather device, and Freakazoid is like, really? This is what you came up with. You came up with all these plans. This was the best you could do. Go home. Try again. Do better. And the guy, like, leaves, and he's, like, crying, and he's like, oh, you're right. I could do better.
Oh, yeah. We'll continue.
That's fine. Continue. And then as soon as the guy is actually like out of earshot, Freak is the one who goes, oh my god, I'm so glad that worked. I had no idea how to stop him. I was going to be screwed.
Dude, it's so good.
Yeah, I
need to watch.
Show.
I need to watch more Freakazoid.
Yeah. What a classic!
Did they make it like a live action Freakazoid?
I don't think so.
They need to.
I don't think so. Yeah, Freakazoid was. I believe it only got like 2 seasons, which is a shame because that show was really special. There's a live action film of Freakazoid.
Yes, there is.
Monday night.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Those ninjas, they're wacky. This is not a wacky situation.
That ninja's got a gun.
This is a fucked up situation.
Oh, shit.
This is not wacky.
Oh, man.
Wacky, not the appropriate
description. Freakazoid had a cat.
Mm-hmm.
Dun, dun. I don't know if... Dun, dun, dun.
Dude down there.
No, no, that can't be real. Steven Spielberg.
Well, he created the original Freakazoid.
Oh, he did too.
He did too. Yeah, so it kind of makes sense that he would be involved in a live action.
But 2019.
2019 is very
That was like
recent.
A year ago.
Feels like I should have heard about that.
Yes, thank you.
Whoa.
But that means we should be able to find it pretty fucking easily.
That's true. Yeah, there we go. Slam around.
Well, I like it because it takes out other people.
Oh, it's so good. It reminds me of the Ninja Turtles, like, throw, because it's like, I mean, it makes you invincible, you bash them around, it's really no downside.
Dun, 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 dun. Roundhouse.
Yep. Dun, 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 dun. But no, I mean, you're definitely not wrong, but there is not a lot to this game. It is a lot of punching ninjas. We got some good music going on.
For now, yeah.
We're going to move on from the ninjas pretty soon here. I forget how many like areas are in this chapter, but I'm pretty sure this is the last ninja chapter. I love that one. And then once you're out of, once we're out of the ninjas, we have a whole new set of enemies to fight for a while. Yeah, slam around. Do-do-do-do-do. Good, yep.
Get him.
You know, this really was the style of game on the SNES.
Dude,
for a long
time. I would imagine this game would be. Did that dude just commit suicide?
I don't know what happened there. He's fucked up.
God, what was the warning that was gonna fucking happen?
That was amazing.
Like, what kind of person is like, okay, so we're going to get him to fall, so the guy just needs to stand right here. Jesus.
Oh my god, that was amazing. Do-do-do. Yep, good. Slam around. Da-da-da. Give him a flick. Yeah.
Okay, we're not hitting anybody, guy.
Yeah, that doesn't happen.
Let's just see. Run into my fist.
I remember playing a lot of this. I remember playing a lot of a Superman beat-em-up Death and Return of Superman.
Oh, I've got that one too.
Oh, that's in the store?
Yep.
Okay. He is...
Well, that was backwards, yeah, but I'll run with that.
Wrong side.
Yeah, so we got that. So this came in that big-ass trade I took a few days ago.
Massive trade.
That I'm still fucking processing. And the thing is, we've been buying, like... Uh-huh. Normally, if we take a big trade in a week, that's generally it.
Right, right.
So, you know, so we bought the almost 600 games off this dude.
Hey!
Oh, fuck yeah!
Robert Peterson, now following.
Nice.
Thanks, Robert.
So, yeah, I bought, like, you know, 600 games off this dude.
Right.
And then on Saturday, I bought another 100 games off of someone else.
Oh, my God.
So the store is...
Hey, yes. Paul!
So the store is just fucking, just, games are fucking everywhere right now. And I don't want to process the ones from the new trades until I get done with the ones from the big
previous
lot.
Trade, yeah.
And testing 420 NES games is just time consuming.
Yeah, it is.
In fact, that's what Andrew's doing right now. Thank you, Andrew.
I can just drop Trevor off. Can't run away.
Well, the thing is, it's really a one-person job.
Yeah.
You know, so it's just, yeah, you can't you can't really speed it up unless I take it home and set up another Super Nintendo or something somewhere else. So it's just it's just not.
Yeah. Damn. That guy's still alive.
Yeah.
Oh man. Yeah, it's a lot. It's a lot to go through.
Yeah. So it's
and it keeps being a lot to go through. Mrs. Lag says we'll give Andrew cookies.
Why would we give Andrew cookies? That's his job.
You can give your employees treats sometimes.
I do. Mm-hmm. I do. But still, that's his job.
Oh wow. That's the first object we've seen that we can pick up and throw.
That you've noticed.
That we've noticed. Andrew is working hard.
You can give him cookies. I mean, you can do whatever you want. I don't care. You're you. Fuck Andrew, this being in the fridge. Go nuts. I just like. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Give him the flick.
Look how confident you are, Mr. Black. Punk.
Hey! Robert Peterson. Thank you very much. For 3 months.
Yeah. Long hauling. Dude, we're about to die.
You got seven lives. You're fine. Whatever.
You know what? I have yet to use an Arthur.
Yeah.
Where's the button? There we go.
Here comes Arthur.
You did jack shit, my dude.
He killed them all.
At least he did that.
It really does seem like a game that should have had a two-player function, and second player should have been Arthur, right? Like, that kind of seems like the most
I feel like if they would have done two-player, mm-hmm. it would have been like Samurai Western two-player, where the second player is just completely fucking useless.
Yeah, I mean, that is how you have to do it for Arthur to be.
All he does is chip damage.
Yeah, exactly. You know? Twitch removed my original account, so I had to make a new one and resub. Well, welcome back, and thank you.
That sucks. Why did Twitch remove your account?
It's a good question.
Want the answer.
That is also the question.
Dangerous question.
That is a very dangerous.
He says he has no clue what happened. Hey, Arch, welcome.
Hey.
You've joined us just in time. We're currently punching ninjas, and what you've missed so far.
The first Freakazoid.
Oh.
But the 2017 one is real.
How is there a 2017 Freakazoid movie and we not know about it?
It's called the Freakazoid fan film.
Mm. Okay.
It's a fan film.
Well, I don't know if it's an actual fan film.
Okay.
This is Freakazoid. Okay.
Yeah, but what fans are there for Freakazoid?
I'm on IMDb right now. The title of it is called
50% of the Freakazoid fans are in this room.
Yeah, no shit.
The story for the film is, it's been over 20 years since Hollywood has returned any of his calls. Now with no options left, Freakazoid chose an unlikely indie filmmaker to help him create his own fan film.
That sounds great.
Will it be any good?
Yeah, that sounds really good.
I fucking
good.
Love Freakazoid.
We gotta track that down.
Freakazoid, yeah, I'm on it. I'm on it.
Down.
Wait, in fact, Mrs. Lag, can you see if the library can get it?
the Freakazoid fan film. Gavin says Arthur would be the equivalent of Tails in Sonic 2. Archclown says Tails is more competent, unless it's taxes, and then Arthur has him beat.
I need to hire Arthur for my taxes.
Robert says, is this a night level or is the game really blue? I'm pretty sure it's night.
It's just blue.
I'm pretty sure it's night.
No, it's a tick.
It's movie night. When it's movie night, it's blue. That's film magic, okay? We can't have you actually be in dark, so we gotta put you in blue so that it still looks kind of dark.
Oh, it was like how Mexico is just like this haze of yellow or some shit like
whenever
that.
Whenever characters go to Mexico, it's like
or
yellow.
Or a third
and
world
hazy.
Country,
LA is always orange.
Yeah, it's true. Robbie says, the tick and knuckles. Welcome, Robbie. Gavin says, really blue. And Mrs. Lag says, thumbs up picture.
All right, thanks, dude. I appreciate it.
Yeah, you got it. You got to have the blue light to convey nighttime. It's really important.
Those are the rules, I guess. Mm-hmm. God, these ninjas are just everywhere.
There's a lot of them. I like how someone has graffitied in the background just punk and cheer face on the walls. That's it. We don't need anything else.
God, is that what that says?
Oh, hey, Siler.
He hit me.
Yes, Siler, the chain chomp is our buffer zone.
Yeah, so I don't like people, so we need space.
It's the personal area bubble. Chain, yeah. Chomp, Chain Chomp is the demilitarized zone.
Wow!
Are you guys at war?
Wow!
I feel like you're okay with each other.
It's that's why. A, so that's why Mrs. Lag was in between us yesterday,
it's,
right?
It's not a perfect analogy,
especially since I gave you a communism soda a few weeks ago. Jesus, is there something you haven't told us,
Robert?
Or
Robert,
me.
Yeah, yo.
Robert asked, "Does that make Adrian North Korea?" But seeing it, I don't know.
Well, I'm from the South.
It's not.
I'm
a perfect,
from the South.
It's not a perfect.
And also,
I am north.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
no,
true.
I'm from the South, just very deep South.
Very deep South.
Thank you.
Siler says, unless you're at war, or are you at war, or are you star-crossed lovers across the border?
Oh,
it's the star-crossed lovers one.
Wow.
I mean, seriously.
Wow.
That's what.
We did say we were going to spoon today, so I mean, makes sense.
Got to show the people at home the spoon.
Oh yeah.
It's there over it there.
Spoon.
God, the best spoon. Mrs. Lag found it, I believe.
It's beautiful. And it moves.
No, it speaks.
Well, it speaks. It speaks.
It speaks.
Every single time?
Every single... Oh, what happened?
We're good now.
I don't know.
There was a momentary break there.
Sorry, I kept on fighting. I was a trooper.
Keep mashing that button. Oh, are you trying to hold it up in the camera? There you go. There you go.
Look at that spoon.
Siler says, very good spoon. Gavin says, aren't you afraid Chay Chomp will bite? Robert says, Adrian lying again. Australia doesn't exist. He isn't from the South.
He could still be from the South and also have Australia not exist.
I mean,
get off the table.
So the thing I don't understand is some people think Australia's not real and we're just paid actors.
That seems like a lot to try and cover.
Flat Earth is.
Sure.
Yeah.
So the thing is, you choose Australia not to be real, not New Zealand, the smaller version of Australia. Right?
So,
since the Lord of the Rings was in New Zealand, we're going to keep it.
Okay, yeah.
But Australia's not real. And fine, Australia's not real. Where the fuck is my royalty checks? Okay?
Where's all your deep state money, Adrian?
Right, where is it? I wouldn't be fucking selling video games if we were faking this shit.
Maybe they pay you. Oh,
shit. No, once again,
fine.
Do I look like I have a lot of money? Okay? Jesus. Trust me. I'm one of those people that if I have a lot of money, oh, you'll be like, that asshole again. Yes.
Gavin says the Earth is not round or flat. It's a trapezoid.
I feel like the Earth is a Pringle can.
Okay. See, the Earth is a cylinder.
Yeah, okay. But it's like hollow Earth. This is where I'm going.
Oh my God!
All right, because it's a Pringle can, and we're on the outside of the Pringle can, and you know somebody's popped us, so we can't stop, and you know it's just perfect.
Someone popped us.
Because
once you pop, fun don't stop.
Right.
Okay. I understand.
Are we having fun?
I understand. I wonder where our
I
top
am.
Is
Shit.
Is the moon our top, floating in space?
Yes! Yes! It is!
That was the top. It popped, and now it's just drifting away.
Oh, my God, yes. We
drifting away.
Drifting away.
Oh, my God.
Robert says the Earth is on the back of a space-flying turtle. Thank you, Robert, for that little reference there.
Which one?
Discworld.
Don't think
it's a Terry Pratchett series of books that was
okay. Yeah,
monumental when I lost. But yeah,
you just said books.
Yeah,
you could have just said books.
It's from books, Adrian. It's from books.
Books.
Ask Mrs. Lag. But yeah, so in Discworld, the world is on the back of a turtle flying in space. It's great.
So Mrs. Lag just bought me a book, and it was the cutest fucking book.
Okay, what was the book?
It was called, I think it's called Little Truck.
That's pretty good. We're off to a good start.
It's called Little Truck. It's a board book.
Good.
Like Tori something.
Okay.
And oh my God, it's just the cutest little thing. I've read it like 9 times. It's the greatest.
Fantastic. The Mrs. Lag plan to get you reading books. She's going to give you slightly more complicated books every time.
Oh, I guess so.
Gavin says, a Ninja Turtle? No, it's just a turtle. It's just a turtle with a whirl on its back. And Siler asks, what tier would the tick fall under for beat-em-ups? I'd give this a solid,
pick up the wheelchair.
Give it a B.
There we go.
I missed.
There was one enemy.
I missed. I completely missed. Okay. I got it down now.
Little truck. Yes.
I got it down. Perfect.
You linked it.
We welcome any links to books in this.
So, yeah.
Well, hold on. We welcome links to most books in this
channel. Wow, you have opened it up.
Any link to Mrs. Lag Post is good for books. All right, here we go.
Oh, man, we should moderate Mrs. Lag so she has the power.
Yeah, we should.
Oh, I can do that.
Now I'm suddenly not having any problems with smacking them around.
I just unlocked it. It's fine.
Yeah, you unlocked it, and it's all good from there. Oh, well, that guy went down with
a kick. Taro Gomi, that's it. Taro Gomi was the dude's name.
Super cute little boy.
Okay.
He goes up the hill, he slows down, gets nudged up by the dad truck, then he gets fired. That's beautiful.
That's great, yeah.
Oh, man, yeah, little truck.
A lot of drama there.
Dude, he gets lost.
Wow.
They find him, don't worry. They find him.
Spoilers for Little Truck.
Oh, trust me. This is Spencer. Spoilers on. Every time I read it, I'm like, oh no, where's the Little Truck? Oh, I got, there he is. That's great.
We are now fighting our way through a hospital, it appears. A lot of big open space in this hospital.
Who are the Tick's enemies, and why do they just look like the Foot Clan from the Turtles
in
Time?
Oh, yeah. So the way...
Because they're ninjas.
Yeah. So we're fighting a ton of ninjas. I don't remember who the first boss is, but they're
the ninja.
Like... Probably a ninja. But yeah, so the enemies in the Tick were all references to, like, other comic book things. But, like, one of them was Chairface, is one of the big enemies in the Tick. And it's literally a guy with a chair face.
Yeah, but what's the reference to other enemies for that?
I gotta think about this one. I know American Maid is very obviously a Wonder Woman. Oh God.
Why is Gavin making a link about poop?
It's
oh no.
A link of a book.
Yeah.
About
as soon as I said the words, I regretted them. I knew something like this would happen.
Oh, that's a real cute truck.
It's a good truck.
It is, right? Adrian's new favorite book.
Yeah.
Return of the Golden Age of Comics. Like, I'm not clicking clicking anybody's link here.
Do you remember what the name is of the character on the Tick that's kind of like a Deathstroke style character? Crazy vigilante who just blows people up.
Well, yeah, I only remember him from the live action one.
Yeah.
He had a cool voice.
He did. He was great. I just don't remember what the character's name was, but I just remember his whole thing is just he's just out there murdering everybody.
I would that would be like the anti-hero.
Yeah.
He was an anti-hero.
Yes. He was very much created as a response to like the Punisher.
If
and,
I would
those
be
types
a superhero, that's the type of superhero I would love to be.
You go full Punisher.
Oh, not even like, okay, so I saved the city, but 20,000 people died, but the city is saved. On the plus side, look at all this real estate up for grabs.
Right.
And cheap.
Wow.
You know?
That is anti-hero. You're really thinking big.
Think
there.
About it. If I'm going to save for the thing and some people may die, just think other people could move in. Cheap real estate, already furnished.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, yeah, that's true. Wow.
Jesus.
I mean, that's... Wow. That's a... The Opportunist.
It would be.
That's your hero name, the Opportunist.
I mean, property value would go down since a whole bunch of houses would go up for sale at once.
It would be really
cheap. Like, think about it. I am stimulating the economy one death at a time.
You know, I mean, housing is definitely one of the biggest costs that our generation faces. So,
We
need that to come down.
Yeah, and the way to do that is just to be a superhero that murders people for good.
You're looking at the big picture here. That's really what it is.
Adrian's just thinking, what if Robin Hood had a gun?
Yeah.
What if Batman just used his money for good instead of dressing around like in a suit?
Yeah.
Really,
that
really.
A lot.
You know, I won't have money. I'll just murder people. That bad people. And if an innocent got thrown in there, they got thrown in there.
Did you see the newest Batman movie by any chance?
No.
Okay.
No, I don't like Batman.
Okay.
Once again, nothing's impressive with a guy that has money. Like, give me money and training, and I can be a, like I could be skilled in hand-to-hand combat.
Most people could be superheroes at that point.
Yeah.
You feel.
Yeah, like he's got all these cool gadgets. He's got a butler.
He does have a butler. Like, oh, know. God, that sword took out like half my health.
Oh, yeah, the
don't
swords.
Get hit by the swords.
The swords are evil. So I just feel like, you know, like Tony Stark. Tony Stark, like,
oh yeah.
Like, granted,
all
he
money,
made
all
that
the technology,
suit.
Yeah.
But if he didn't have the that's money why, and all those cool little nanobots and shit like that.
Well, that's
what makes
yes,
the...
Yeah.
That's what makes the first Iron Man movie kind of great is because he had
he
to
built
build,
it in the cave.
He had to build it in the cave, yeah, with the parts that were available as opposed to when he had all the resources in the world to build a new one.
Boomerang Man.
Boomerang Man. Boomerang Man. Wow.
Yeah. Adrian would be Kangaroo Man. Fuck you guys. Wow, fuck you guys. It is very racist.
This is pretty fucked up, Chad.
I know.
Asked if you did that
game. Yeah,
that was pretty
bad. I don't.
That wasn't great.
Like, it,
not one of my fighter
how
moments.
How is it like? It, the thing is, like, it's just so. Then why isn't your Captain America slinging guns all the fucking time?
Yeah, true.
Our it's Captain, totally not Captain America.
Our Captain America really should just be.
He's
unloading.
Too nice, too. Yeah. He's in shape. He's polite. No, this is not the America I know. It's got values. Fuck that. Oh, God.
Oh, my God. Nick says Captain America is the idealized version of America, you know. From a certain point of view, it's the Jedi that are evil.
Oh, man.
The special powers are getting
drunk on punch. Just punch nothing.
Jesus.
Oh, man.
Yeah. It's okay. I got it. Oh my God.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, that was...
That's rough.
That was savage.
That took... That
was savage.
I mean, fine. I'll get the Aboriginals. You got the Indian. Like, it's... We can go toe-to-toe for this one.
I was going to say, Captain America would also have a long history of displacing indigenous people.
Yeah. Whoa.
Yeah. No. Oh, no! Oh, okay, here he is.
Is that the boss?
God.
He just kicked the fuck out of you.
Yeah, he did. Arthur,
kick him back.
Arthur, a little help here?
No, Arthur.
No
Arthur's
Arthur.
And bosses, apparently.
Wow. Fuck you, Arthur.
Arthur's usually kidnapped during a boss fight.
That's true.
True.
I appear to only be able to hit him once, and then he kind of just gets invincibility. It's kind of fucked up in my book.
Man, you gotta admit the animation in this game is really good.
It's great. I dig it. This is some bullshit.
Get good, scrub.
This is some bullshit.
Like, we know you hit him and then you back off. And then you go back and you hit him.
Lost another life.
Audio
there.
Is
okay.
Buzzing a bit.
Is it now? Okay.
Mm.
Yeah, I'll need to take a look at that after he's done kicking my ass.
Yeah, is it one or the other, or is it buzzing for everybody? Yeah.
Nick says these hitboxes are classic SNES.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah, this motherfucker is not... It's like I can only hit him at very specific... He seems to have invincibility frames for most of his attacks. So this is proven to be a challenge. Oh, my God.
No, there's no Arthur attacks, Gavin.
Yeah, Arthur's not allowed to come out during bosses.
It peaks when there's
out.
A lot of noise.
Peaks when there's a lot of noise. Yeah. I can fix that. That's a fixable thing.
All right, we'll work on it.
Yeah, I got it. I got it as soon as I'm done getting slashed up.
Sifu 1994.
That's really good.
Oh, man. Yeah, but the tick doesn't age.
Oh, God.
Well, okay. We don't know if he ages or not.
He's a giant
Well,
mystery.
He doesn't even know when he was born or his name is The Tick.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, he's an amnesiac. So
tick, tick, comma, the...
A what?
Amnesiac.
I don't
know.
Oh, amnesia.
Yeah, it's a
fancy
word for a person who doesn't remember things.
Wow, it's not...
How's that?
It's just the word for someone who doesn't remember things.
For Adrian, it's fancy.
Okay.
For Adrian, it's fancy. Thank you.
We did it. Let's go to Ninja World. Oh, my God. There's more ninjas? I thought we were done.
Hawaiian shirt. Is that eggs?
Okay. Let me go ahead and...
There better be, like, a different enemy than this. Oh, nope. Should we mention how racist it is that we're now in, like, a Chinatown with ninjas?
Yeah, that's kind of racist.
It could be better. This could be from the show. We don't know.
That would not make it better,
babe. Well, the show is from the 90s, and we are playing...
Still doesn't make it better.
I'm not saying it makes it better.
It's
I'm just...
In its time.
I'm putting it in its historical context. We are putting it in its historical context and then simultaneously saying, this isn't great. It's a bad look. It's just, it's a comprehensive
It is a look,
look
though.
Yeah, it's a look. Look.
It's a look. I'm going to kick the shit
it's
out of somebody.
A comprehensive Come bad here. Look.
Oh, there's a green ninja. What the fuck?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, so now this is the last ninja stage. Because I remember when the green ninja
But you just had a boss.
I did.
Was he a sub-boss?
I guess he's kind of like a sub-boss.
A mini-boss,
so boss of this stage will be the end of the ninjas. Because I remember once the green ninjas show up, you're on the last stage of ninjas. There's always one new enemy type that only shows up for the final section of your ninja affair.
My ninja affair.
Ninja affair. These ninjas are from Ninja Golf. They look very similar to the ninjas from Ninja Golf. There are even green ninjas in Ninja Golf that blend
in. Oh, dude, we gotta play Ninja Golf one day.
One of these days, yeah. But you said there was like an Atari collection that has
Yeah,
one,
the
right?
Atari 50.
Yeah.
I believe. Yeah, I just got that traded in.
Nice.
Do-do-do-do-do.
Yeah, you'll finally bring honor to your family in Ninja Golf.
No.
Gavin says the green ninja is the only smart one in Ninja Golf, which is true.
It's an Atari game. Yeah. There's no smart anything in that. I do like it how the guys with the sword, when you pick them up, they drop the sword and
yes.
just, they don't get it again.
Yes, it's also true of the guys that have the size. As soon as you hit them once, they like drop them.
I wish we could pick them up.
That sure would be nice. This game is very stingy on things that you can pick up and throw, and we have not hit anybody with anything we could pick up yet.
Wheelchairs and mailboxes.
Mailbox,
which is
yeah.
why the mail's always fucking late.
Oh, yeah, no. In this world, you're lucky if you get it at all. You're better off just driving the mail to somebody's house and putting it in the slot yourself.
Maybe the tick was a mailman.
We wouldn't. We have no way of knowing.
I know.
Could be.
He is a dude, so good chance he is a male.
It's near, there's a down there at least. It's good to collect data on what we know. We know he's ripped. We got that.
No, we don't know that. It could be markings in the suit.
Well,
the thing is, he's strong. Mm-hmm. That doesn't necessarily equate to being in shape.
Okay,
yes.
Okay. But we can see that he's got, well, I mean, I guess it could be the suit.
It could be the suit. Yeah, it could be the suit. I mean, don't you have a shirt that's, you know, that the pattern is like abs and shit?
No, we never let him on.
We're going to, oh, you don't have to.
Arch Clown says Ninja World lol. And Robbie says a conspicuous lack of what cooked turkeys hiding behind garbage cans in this game. Yeah, not a whole lot of ways to get your health back. In fact, I think the only way to get your health back is just to beat the stage.
Or die.
Or die. That would get your health back. What is going on with this sign? Underworld Oddities Snack Bar.
I want to go to a snack bar. Fuck yeah.
Snack bar sounds good. Da 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 da.
Oh, Mrs. Lag, are you still in here? I
dig in the music.
There's something in the store that you needed that I left there by accident.
Oh,
so, Mrs. Lag, if you're in here, show me a sign.
Mrs. Lag, are you in the room with us right now?
Look at the light. Right in the book, Mrs.
Oh my god. Gavin says I could go for a telephone booth chicken.
Floor meat.
Floor
yeah,
meat.
Floor
classic.
Meat.
That's a classic beat 'em up thing, floor meat.
Woo! Okay.
Mrs. Lag is here.
So there is pizza downstairs on the Aunt Kathy came. There's pizza downstairs on the where is it? The dolly. That is a weird statement, but there's pizza on the dolly downstairs.
Oh my god, a dolly.
Wait, like basement downstairs?
No, 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 lag, because there's a dolly in lag. But yeah, so there's a bag of pizza sitting on the thing of the dolly.
Okay, good.
Just letting you know, my dude.
Unless Andrew's eating it already.
Andrew, why would he eat floor pizza?
I don't know, why do you guys eat floor chicken?
Because it's in the game.
I personally do not eat floor chicken, but...
Bullshit. So you're playing a game and you won't eat floor chicken?
Oh, if I'm playing a game, I eat all the floor chicken. Yeah, okay.
That's
yeah, that's true. Here's a question, Adrian. Mm. How often did you play a game like Final Fight or Streets of Rage with someone else? That question is worse than I expected it to be.
With someone
quite,
else.
That wasn't that was
Adrian,
quite.
How much of a loner are yeah, you?
A huge one.
That was a huge loner. Actually, that was supposed to be a setup to something else. I wasn't trying to drag you there, but.
How many friends do you have, Adrian?
So
none.
What I was gonna ask is, are you the type of player who would try to run to get the food to deny the other person from getting it?
100%.
Okay, yeah.
100%. Did you not know that when we were playing Turtles?
I was just kind of putting it together. That's all.
Trevor knows that too, by the way.
Yeah. I mean, it depends. Like,
depends what you're playing with.
No, it depends what I like. A lot of games I just play to fuck around in. But sure, sometimes yeah. I will be serious.
Oh.
Like if I'm playing with Kevin, sometimes I have to be serious.
Okay, I mean that makes sense from what I've heard of Kevin's skills in Mortal Kombat in particular.
It's not even that, like sometimes when we play Destiny, sometimes I don't want to play.
Gotcha.
All right, so I shoot the ground.
Okay.
But other times, like I know it's going to be rough, so I'm helping, you know?
Okay.
But I'm helping like the 5-year-old helps his dad move the lawn helping. He's not really doing anything, but he's like, I'm helping.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's me.
Okay, great.
You know? So, but, you know.
Robert says in quotes, Adrian, how fucking alone are you, loser? It was not my intention, but I understand that that was how it came across.
Oh, God. Yeah, that's exactly how it came across, Trevor.
Do you have any friends?
I'm not gonna repeat it. I'm not gonna. I was about to say what I.
There's a reason why I like RPGs, Trevor. Is that what you want to know?
Oh God.
There's a Player 2 port on my PS2 that's never had anything put into it. Okay.
It's just pristine.
It's spiderwebbed over.
Oh my God.
We just taped over it so dust didn't get in there. It's fine. No, I stand corrected. No, okay. It probably did get used if I ever played Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah, sure. Oh, yeah, because Psycho Mantis.
Yeah, 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 yeah. I never did, but yeah, it could have been used. Okay, yeah.
If you had played Metal Gear, that is a section you would have had to switch the controller ports. Ah, man, what a game. I fucking love Metal Gear.
Yeah, I suck at it.
I played through that game so many times.
Yeah, see, I only had the demo.
Ah, yes.
And I just liked smoking cigarettes and then get into the box.
Yeah.
That's all I did.
I don't think you could do too much more because I believe the demo ended in the snow base, right?
No, so you could go, you had the smoke bombs and with the cameras and shit like that, you know.
Arch Clown says, wait, you're talking with Adrian about playing games? What bizarro world is this? Oh, Paul the Samurai's back. Ooh, I'm not happy about the Buddha Palace here. That is not Buddha.
He's white.
Okay.
He's very white. Just letting you know. I don't know if you can see it, but he's white.
Okay, that part is also wrong. But Buddha was also not the big fat like character that you see everywhere. That's a totally different deity.
Buddha,
yeah, it's not. It's not the Buddha. Yeah, but there's like a I don't remember the name of it, but there's like a it became very popular to kind of use that as the Buddha.
It's the lucky one.
Yeah, it's the lucky one.
It wants the stomach that you touch for good luck.
Yeah.
Robert says Adrian doesn't play games. He just gets excited to play one and then boosts it up and stares at the menu screen and then loses interest.
Atomic Heart.
Well, you Atomic Heart you bailed on after some informed, after trying to start it.
Right? Oh, dude, yeah. But the start was just so fucking long. My dude, I don't have that long to do this shit, okay? But I did play some more Slay the Spire today.
Nice. Yeah, that one's been had some staying power for you.
It has. I checked. I've got 98 hours in it.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't know how many of that is just me standing ready to choose a path and then going to make some food or some shit, but still. So that's a lot of hours for me.
You're right.
But I did finally beat my my first daily climb today.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Oh, dude, it was a stupid build. It was my favorite.
I don't know if I've never done that before in Slay the Spire. I've never actually finished the like daily challenge. That
I did. What was my first one today? You get an achievement. Oh, I got a trophy with it.
Well done.
But yeah, I was just it was a stacking strength type of thing. So at the end of the battle, like the boss battle, I will add 50 some odd strength. Like your attack that does 6 is now doing 50. It's fine. It's fine. We're good. You
that
know.
Feels good. It feels good. Like that.
God, yeah. You know, my last hit took 100 and something did 100 and something damage. It's nice.
Arch says, wow, Robert, even if it's true, just calling him out like that is rude. And Robert says,
I would expect nothing less from my customers.
I was going to say, Robert says, yeah, but it's funny.
Yeah, thank you. God.
It reminds me of the Simpsons meme that goes around of Marge saying, I mean, it's true, but you shouldn't say it.
Well, the thing is, I give a lot of my customers shit. Yeah. So, I mean...
You
dish
gotta
it back.
It. Yeah. You got to take it in return. Yeah. That's how the exchange works.
Right. And if anything, I'll just run in the basement and cry for a few minutes. It's fine. Like,
there's an arcade cabinet down there. You know.
There's none in the basement.
Your basement. Okay. I'm thinking about this basement. You know,
what? Yes. Hold on. I'm going to close the store. I'm going to run into your basement from the store.
I was.
Trevor, they're being mean to me. Okay. Let me play the cabinet.
I was thinking about, like, if they made you cry here from saying mean things in chat. But I understand now that what you mean is if they make you cry in the store while they are present and shopping. Right?
Yeah.
There we go.
Kuma says hi.
Hey, Kuma. Welcome.
Ah. It's my little brother.
Oh. Welcome. Da, 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 da. You're just in time to watch us punch ninjas.
Or die. Either way.
Which is very different from the last... hour.
Hey, listen, man, they're green ninjas this time, okay? Like, but I don't know if a green ninja suit is a smart choice.
It's for the green suit.
Ninja golf, it's perfect.
Because they're on grass.
Exactly. Here, not as great.
Hi. God, I hate it how they just reappear.
Yep, yeah, there's a cat here, Robert. He's making himself known. He's making himself known. Come here. The chat wants to see you. Get here. Gavin says it wasn't shit water that flooded Adrian's basement. It was Adrian's tears. Jesus Christ,
oh,
Gavin.
Man.
Jesus Christ.
He's finally getting there. He's finally roasting back.
Gavin's,
look
yeah.
how much he's grown.
Oh, I'm so proud.
Oh, my God, yes.
You did. You raised that
boy. My little cat, Gavin.
Oh. Yes, there are actually two cats present in this house, but one of them
is a void.
I was gonna say you'll never see her on camera.
Unless I got some food or bread.
If you got some food or
bread,
that might get her. Yeah. Oh, she fucking loves
dude,
bread.
Dude, I had a dog. I had a miniature dachshund. Weighed all of 7 pounds. Okay,
wow.
So it's a tiny miniature dachshund. Ate a full loaf of bread. Now this loaf of bread was as long as she was. Dude, her stomach dragged
oh
on the floor.
God. Dog.
And I feel really bad because I didn't notice that she had eaten a whole bag of bread, right? A whole loaf. And I was hugging my girlfriend at the time in the kitchen. And I looked down and I'm like, damn, you're fat. So she thought I was talking about her and not my dog. Dude, that was awkward. It was great.
What a perfect storm. The dog ate all the bread and you accidentally called your girlfriend fat.
Oh, dude, that was great.
What a day.
Oh. I mean, we give Adrian shit, but who's the smarter one?
Where? Who's the smarter one because they're all handing you their...
Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah. Morons.
<That's true>. Oh, man.
Oh.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
I don't get it.
Yeah.
I don't get it.
I feel like there's a checklist of, like, good business practices, and you do the opposite of them, and
still
succeed.
Works.
Yeah.
It works.
And you nail it.
Yeah. People are like, you want to be a mentor? I'm like, no. No.
No one should learn from
you
me.
Do not need to know what I, like, how this works.
Right. Robert says, Adrian Dumb Wall buys 12 NES games.
Dude, I had somebody drive 8 hours for a trade-in for us. So I'm doing something right. Dude drove 8 hours.
That's crazy. I'm trying to think of any game I would be so excited to buy, I would drive 8 hours for
it. Well, we weren't selling him something. We were buying something. We were buying. So he drove past who knows how many game stores.
A lot.
This dude drove past.
A lot. Depending on where he was driving from.
8 hours.
8 hours.
Like we can get champagne. We'll do an 8 hour circle, and I'll read.
How many he passed.
Minnesota, I believe.
Okay.
I don't know. I'm not sure, but yeah, 8 hours. So like depending, it's still like if he came from the north, there's a lot in Chicago area. If it's if it's the east, he has to assuming driving by like. Danville, there's two in Danville, there's a few in Indianapolis, Ohio will get that one.
A lot in Ohio.
If he's coming from the south, there's the St. Louis and all that shit area,
There's no shortage of game stores.
The west, he's got to go through Bloomington where the item shop is, like, nope.
Stockholm Syndrome. Mrs. Lag says customer loyalty.
Oh, man. Yeah, but I had to get them as customers somehow.
Yeah.
Maybe it's all their kink. I don't know. They like it. They all like it.
They're all like, this Australian will talk to me like this. I have to go.
Oh, my God.
You know, some of my customers don't even know I'm Australian. That's the weird thing.
What do they think you are?
I'm just a guy that speaks funny.
Oh, okay.
Some of them don't even know I have an accent, and I don't understand that.
I do have to wonder about that one.
You have an accent? I think I do. Yeah. Like, I don't hear it.
Oh, my God. Life. I've never seen that before in this game. I was going to say, at skee-ball, it's a whole thing to try and mimic your accent.
Is it? Oh, yeah. Trevor.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Gotta get the Trevor right.
Either that or Trevor. Yeah, I was going to say, either that or say a word to you over and over again until you don't say it with an accent.
I try that really hard. It's like speaking without an American accent is just really hard for me.
It feels weird to hear it when it happens.
As customer something, I think Robert has a better analogy. He's a New Zealander, obviously. He is a Kiwi. So I like it when people call me a Kiwi, like from New Zealand, because like you don't know any different. So I call him a Canadian. I don't know any different.
Turnabout's fair play.
And some people get offended. Really? I'm not a Canadian. I'm like, I'm not a New Zealander. Like,
I don't know what to tell you.
What are we? Let this be a lesson to you for, making assumptions here. All right? Just because you're an American doesn't mean you're American, clearly, You're almost dead. Never mind.
The axe guy got me. Yeah, he took care of business. It's okay, I picked up a light.
Makes sense. Adrian is fruity. I'm not going to deny that. Oh.
Ninja.
Oh, you missed.
I missed the flick.
So who's the boss since we've already...
I don't remember. I know Chairface is the boss of the next set of enemies.
I had a friend from New Zealand and calling them Australian was equivalent to throwing hands. Yeah, it is. So I like to say to Americans when they get it wrong. And I'm like, oh, calling us, calling me New Zealander is like calling an American a Canadian. We all know they're better than us, but we're not going to admit it, And some people hate the fact that I say that Canada's better than us, that it's better than the U.S.
They hated
great.
Him. They hated him because he spoke the truth. Let's go, Tick.
But it is what it is. I mean, I'm all for New Zealand. They just have more sheep than human there. That's just weird. So much sheep.
We did see a lot of sheep out there.
But that's where Lord of the Rings is from. And I've never really been.
Oh, really?
I stopped there for an hour for a layover, and that's the longest I've ever been in New Zealand.
Were you in, was it in Wellington?
I don't know. Okay. I was 14. It was when I was moving here.
Oh.
That was one of our stops.
And that was it?
That was it. Okay. So I went to go to New Zealand in 2011.
Mm.
So I was looking at tickets and everything, and for whatever reason, I hesitated and didn't buy the ticket.
Oh,
so
no.
I was in Australia, and I'm like, oh, I'll make a weekend trip to New Zealand.
New Zealand, sure, yeah.
And the day I had planned it for the weekend, I had all these plans, I didn't do it. And then the day that I was going to go, they had a 7.8
earthquake. Right, you were right there.
And
the,
I'm like, ooh. Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. I dodged the hugest fucking bullet. And yeah, since then, did. I'm like, I don't want to go to New Zealand.
Yeah,
you know?
We went there in...
The year after that.
We went there, I think it was 2015 that we went, right? 2014.
15 or 16.
Dude.
We went and...
You should buy a few. I'm going to cut into
it. Yeah, go
it.
For
I'm
it. Go for
responding
it.
Responding to ARC real quick. Some people have bought some, so your odds of getting something good is increased.
Oh, the JoJo gotcha. Yes.
This guy bought some.
Hi. Yeah, so Arch, I did two of them, and I got a coaster and a bag. So the statues, as far as I know, are all still
you
there.
Somebody's got... So somebody pulled one ticket and got one of the...
One of the statues. Wow. Okay.
So one's gone, okay. But somebody yesterday pulled two tickets and they got a coaster and a bag.
Same setup, baby.
Yeah.
So Robert, he says the what, but there is a thing you can buy at the store.
Ichiban Kuji.
Number so, one something. Anyway,
so you pull a raffle. You pull a raffle ticket. Everybody's a winner. So $15, you get a ticket. And the ticket's gonna say a letter on it, and based on that letter, we'll pull you a prize that corresponds to that letter. So obviously, you know, the lower the letters, the lower the tier of prize.
Yeah.
But if you pull like an A, B, C, and I believe D for the JoJo ones, you get a statue.
Yeah.
You know, there's also what else? There's cups. And they're pretty big. I thought they were little shot glasses, but they're like
that,
a cup.
Huh? Oh, okay.
A cup. A coaster, a bag. So they're decent. The JoJo ones, in my opinion, are better than the Evangelion ones.
Yeah.
Like everything, you'd be like, okay, $15. Yeah, that makes sense. Where the Evangelion one, oh, pick it up. Yeah.
No, now we're talking. Let's go.
Where the Evangelion ones, like, I dropped $15 on this. You missed. There was three fucking enemies, and you're like, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna thread the needle.
Missed them all, baby.
True skill.
But yeah, all that to say, you can go to LAG and you can get, you can try your luck on the JoJo merchandise.
Yeah, I mean it's pretty cool. Like, so I was meaning to order them, and I'm like, I'm not gonna order it, and
right.
I'm like, I'll wait for the Evangelion one to get lower.
Right.
And then I'll order it.
Oh.
And then one day, USPS drops off this huge box. And I look at it, I'm like, what the fuck is this? You know, I open it and it's the JoJo shit. I'm like, when the fuck did I order this?
At some point.
And so from the company I ordered it from, they take money first and then deliver. Like, so a pre-order. So if I order $1,000 worth of stuff, I pay up front and then whenever it's ready, it ships.
So you buy it and then it just
So that was 7 months ago.
Yeah, I was going to say, it just shows up.
And it just showed up. And I wasn't expecting it because I didn't see the hit in the bank account or anything,
right.
You know?
Yeah, because
like
normal pre-orders would do.
Yeah.
You already took the hit.
Yeah.
Can
I get video games at LAG? No, you cannot, Gavin. But you're the only person who can't.
Yeah, it's all those bands just racking them up. Arch says, big JoJo fan. Me too, Arch. I'm a huge fan.
I've never seen it. I want to watch it.
That's
I heard
great.
It's like they're Italian or something.
It depends on the series. Like the,
really?
So,
okay.
Well, yeah, so each season of JoJo is a different member of the family and a different generation.
Oh, so that's badass.
So as the series goes on, you get different protagonists as it goes on.
Oh.
And so, yeah, the spoon. But, yeah, so the thing that I really like about JoJo is a lot of like shonen anime, like Dragon Ball.
Mm.
Oh my god!
Fuck.
Oh Jesus!
You just
Christ.
Kicked him in the face.
It was all reaction there. Oh man, we got.
I am
going to
be really mean, really quick.
Please do.
Does that kind of look like Sunny? Think Skee-Ball.
Oh.
The face.
It's
the mustache.
A little bit.
Yes.
Yeah.
He has his mustache.
A little bit. This is
legs extend. Extendo legs.
This is the general manager that we're fighting.
Oh, that's right. Yes.
Yeah. Oh my God, he is kicking my ass here.
He's the GM.
Woo! So what I was gonna say is a lot of shonen anime like Dragon Ball. Usually the way that it works is the hero gets super strong, but then they have to have a bad guy that gets even stronger, and that escalation just is the whole series, right?
Right.
Goku hits Super Saiyan, and the next he's got to fight somebody who can beat Super Saiyan, so he's got to go to Super Saiyan 2. JoJo kind of solves that problem by making it so that everybody's ability is something that's like sort of weird. And so instead of the hero having to figure out how to get stronger, they have to figure out how to like get around this like weird set of rules.
So I played the fighting game on the Dreamcast with JoJo, and it was weird.
It's very weird. But like, so one such example, in the most recent one, Stone Ocean, there's somebody who they hit Jolene with this stand. And the way it works is like you make a bet, and if you don't succeed at making the bet, it'll take your life. And so she has to pass a ball 100 times or else she'll die. And so the challenge becomes not how do I beat this person, it becomes how do I manage to keep this ball going all day until I can win and not die.
Is there a time restriction here?
There's not a time restriction. So it's just a matter of holding on to the ball, and the whole time the bad guy, or the bad girl in this case, is trying to get the ball so that she'll fail the challenge. So she has to keep the ball going back and forth between people, and then she also has to not let this other person get in the way. And that becomes the challenge for the remainder of like the episode.
That sounds really interesting.
It's
really gotta watch this shit.
Every battle is sort of like that. So like, you know, in the older one, there is a fight against a gambler, and it's a similar concept where it's like you have to play poker for your life, and you can't win by just punching him. You have to win by playing poker.
Well, generally in poker, you don't win by punching people.
Exactly.
Like, I mean, I've tried that technique. It's not good.
Yeah. There is an episode against somebody who forces you to play a video game. He's got to play like a...
Nice.
I did it. He's got to play like a racing game.
Oh, God, I suck at racing games.
The idea men have landed. We have a new enemy to fight.
Yes.
No more ninjas.
Looks like Haga from... Final
from Final Fight. Fight, but out of shape.
Oh, fuck! Fuck, he did!
You got taken out!
He fucking took me out!
You got
taken
out! But yes, now we fight the idea men.
They're just like ninjas, but with projectiles.
Yeah, they got guns now. No more ninjas, says Robbie. That is correct.
No. Oh my God! Ninjas. Oh my God, what? I didn't notice! I know this guy! I gym with this guy!
Oh,
what's
what,
up,
Robbie?
Dude? Oh,
yeah. Take that to
Yeah, man! Yeah!
Thank you for the sub, the prime sub, Robbie.
Fuck yeah. Gonna see you tomorrow, yeah, Rob?
I think you guys have called him Rabbi, and his name's Rabble.
His name's Rabble?
Rabble Rooster.
Oh, it looked like an eye from where I am. Rabble. Enjoy some Bozo Bucks.
Yes!
From the Busted Back Brigade. That's really good, Rabble. Oh, man.
Now we go to the gym, and I feel like he's my my counterpart at the gym because we both have shitty backs.
Has he also suffered a back injury?
Mm-hmm,
okay,
mm-hmm.
Got it.
So you know, I literally feel his pain sometimes when he hurts his back.
You guys, yeah.
Yeah, you know.
Simpatico.
Oh, dude, yeah.
Yeah.
And he's cool. I like him. He's
good,
cool.
Good.
I have to say that now because he's listening. But still, you know.
As soon as the stream's off, we'll get the truth.
Nah, he's cool.
You can tell it's nighttime again now because it's blue.
Yeah, it's blue.
Yeah, exactly. Movie magic.
I didn't hear that. What? No, it's fine. It's fine. You don't.
nothing, Ravel. Yeah, good. Smack that guy around.
Yeah, there we go. You're like, I feel like the jump really doesn't do anything in this game.
No.
Like, the jump is not needed. Well, I mean, it is, but...
You can't
jump and punch.
The only time the jump... Yeah, you can jump and kick, but you can't jump and punch.
It's bullshit. You can do that in real life.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's effective, but I guess it would
theoretically,
be.
Theoretically, one could do it, yeah.
I mean, yeah, there's so many photos of, you know, like Captain America going through and...
You jump up, hit him on the noggin... Hit him with the overhead.
We just got stop
he
hitting me with a gun.
Down.
I almost whipped out Arthur. Now you're like my Mothman.
I like how the
yes.
Nice, there you go. I like how the gun makes a sound effect like it's firing multiple times, but they just fire one shot.
Okay, I got him. There we go. Look,
took
man.
Him out, and he's dead. He's dead as hell. We finally did it. Oh, man. Oh,
well, they both went to sleep at the same time.
Yeah, went to sleep. Just a little KO, a little knockout.
Boom. Listen, man. Honestly, if we just knock him out, I wish it's kind of like that in real life. If I would have got knocked out and just woken up in my bed, that would have been great. Like, how did I teleport here?
Yeah. Much better than waking up under a truck.
Yeah, yeah. I was just flashing underneath a truck, and then I woke up here. It was great.
Perfect.
I mean, if I was remained knocked out, I mean, it would have been like that for me, you know?
That's true.
This is not my bed. Where's my pants? Would have been the weirdest time to wake up.
Oh, gun down. Let's go. We got plenty of continues. Let's keep working through them here.
We've burnt through two.
Yeah. That's fine. I think there's 14 stages.
14 bosses?
Yeah. 14 stages, not bosses. Because some of the stages are just like, fight a bunch of guys and then you go somewhere else.
As life is.
Yeah, you know.
Well, they showed us really so many enemies, so I was expecting to...
Yeah, well, we're fighting the Idea Men now, so we finally moved on to some new enemies, you know? You know?
Honestly, these guys would do better if they all showed up at once and just did, like, this just wall of fucking bullets.
That is the trick, but yeah.
Telling them how to be, you know,
it'd be a better strategy.
Yes.
Better strategy. Historically, guns have not worked very well on the Tick. It's usually a thing in the show, is that you can't really just shoot the Tick.
I feel like guns and superheroes, they just...
bounce off.
Yeah, it doesn't really happen. Yeah.
Doo-doo-doo.
But the soundtrack is very...
Yeah, we're digging the soundtrack. For an SNES game, pretty good soundtrack.
Right, but it's very repetitive.
It's so repetitive. There's like maybe three songs in the whole
game. It may be better than... what's his name, though? Decap Attack soundtrack.
Decap Attack has some soundtrack and sound effects problems, I would say.
But bro, it's got like a 9.4 on Google.
Does it really?
Something like that. No, the game.
Oh, okay. I like the soundtrack.
98% of people in America can't hate this game. This is what Gavin has told me.
Gavin also says, look on the bright side, you get chicken nuggets. Oh, hey, you got the American made out.
I do like chicken nuggets. The ones that shaped as dinosaurs are really good. They're not dinosaur flavor that we know. Well, I mean, chicken's a dinosaur, right?
Yeah, they're descendants of dinosaurs.
So,
basically the same.
So yeah, I mean, it's actual shape.
Basically the same.
Yeah.
I love the way she walks.
Let's see.
We got this.
Oh, she's like power walking, yeah. I like it how my feet are going forward, but I'm like moonwalking.
It's the power of the Tick, baby.
I can't tell if she's walking backwards or forwards, but Tick is definitely walking forwards.
Da-da-da.
God, his moonwalk is on fucking point.
It's real good.
I want a moonwalk so badly.
Do you ever play any of the Michael Jackson games?
We do have Moonwalker in the store right now.
Good.
For Genesis.
Yes. Every single version of Moonwalker is very different. Like the SNES, the arcade, and the Genesis.
I played the living shit out of the arcade one.
The arcade one is great.
Yes.
The arcade one is wild.
Yeah, no, I played that. I played that in Australia.
Nice.
Because we had this really cool arcade that would have, on like Saturday mornings, it was admission based.
Ah.
And everything was on free play. But
that's always the best way to do it.
Dude, yeah.
There was a place in Long Beach. Oh, there she goes. There was a place in Long Beach where it was like after, was it 10, I think? After 10, no kids were allowed. And then you could go and pay to go in and all the stuff would be set to free. And that was great.
Was it by like water?
It was. I've
been there. I've got a roll of quarters.
Seriously,
I've got been there? I've got a roll of quarters from there.
When were you in Long Beach?
Do I have to tell you I've been?
I guess not. I'm just surprised.
Jesus. When did you travel, Adrian?
Well, let me put it this way. What if
we were all there the same night?
It was through E3. When I was in E3
E3. Okay. That makes sense.
So 2015, all right? That's when I was there, okay?
The only reason I asked is because like, it would be like if you mentioned some place.
Oh, fuck.
Oh man. Like, if you had mentioned someplace, it's the Chainsaw Vigilante.
Oh, man, I should dress up as him as Halloween.
Let's go. Okay.
Does he like punches?
He's pretty tough, but I think you can get him.
Is there kryptonite somewhere?
There is not kryptonite. There's no trick to this one. You just got to knock
there
him
out. There is a trick. You've got to punch him.
Well, yeah, the trick is you got to punch him, and I think you can only hit him once.
He runs really fast.
He does. Yeah, that
He's
dash.
Got reach. Fuck.
Yeah, that dash is the real problem.
I got a foot. There we go.
There you go. So, yeah, I think you can only hit him once, and then you have to back off. You're getting a lot of good kicks in here.
Because my kick is longer than his arm.
Yeah. Oof. Oh, yeah, fuck. It's always that.
We'll run.
Gavin says I like making the dogs dance in Moonwalker. That is great.
Ooh. So yeah, I didn't know that place did have like adult only time. That would have been great when I went.
Yes. It was like, nice, you got him. It was like any it was after 10, kids weren't allowed anymore.
Oh,
and then
shit,
adults
could
go and just hang out in the arcade.
Okay.
You had to pay a fee, yeah. There was like an upfront fee to get in at that point.
I
don't remember.
It was like
$15.
I mean, that's not bad. I would have done that.
It was $15 for all you can play.
There was like a diner nearby, right?
Yeah,
I ate there. That was a cool diner. There was like an Australian-esque style restaurant there, but they were closed.
Yeah. That whole section, it's called the Pike. And that whole section is now kind of just a very sad, empty series of storefronts. COVID did not do well for the Pike, yeah.
Is the arcade still there?
No, it's gone.
Oh, man.
No longer around. Yeah, it's a bummer.
Yeah, no, I paid the money, and I'm like, I'm going to keep one of these quarters.
Uh-huh.
And when I was going through my rough time, I'm like, I'm staring at the quarters, and it's because it's like 10 bucks in quarters. I'm like,
I could make use of this somehow, yeah.
And I'm just staring at it. I'm like, these are just normal quarters, my dude. I'm like, yeah, but the inside, the outsides is different, you know?
Spoon.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, all there. Gavin.
Oh, bullshit!
Oh, that was
you
bullshit.
Was already fucking
that was
dead!
Bullshit. That was bullshit. We got it.
It's like stepping on a dead bee and getting stung.
We got proof. That was some bullshit. Gavin says XXX arcade.
XXX?
Oh. Because it's an adults only arcade.
Oh,
so
yeah.
XXX arcade.
Well, there was this place on what is it? Springfield, yeah, that was just said arcade.
That's
and for the longest time, I'm like,
yeah, I thought that was an arcade.
Me too, it's yeah. not.
It's not, it's just a gambling house.
No, it was an adult store.
Oh.
Oh, wait, oh, we're thinking about different arcades.
It has a fence around it.
Oh, yeah, that one.
Yeah, yeah, it used to be called Illini Arcade.
Yeah.
It's and I'm like, bitchin', we've got an arcade. So we go there with my friends and shit. Some of them were more excited than I was.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah.
I definitely had that experience when I turned 18, where the first thing some of my friends wanted to do was go to an adult store. Because it was like, oh, man, can't wait to finally go in here. and I feel like very underwhelmed. Very underwhelmed by my experience in an adult store.
I feel like
store.
You would be awkward. Like, I would be awkward as fuck.
It's not
I wouldn't want to get close to anybody.
No.
You know?
Very unpleasant. Through and through.
And then you get
visibly
nauseous.
Yeah. Yeah.
I can see you do that.
Rabble says, not an arcade, and then he says, the Urbana News. In quotes.
Oh, there was one called the Urbana News?
I guess so. Gavin says, I want to walk in and ask if they have a Mario Arcade on Xbox. Good luck with that.
He did that to me today. Oh, the boss man!
The forehead! Yeah, smack the forehead.
Ooh. He's got a gun.
He does. He's got grenades, too. Oh, my
Fuck.
God! Grenade fucks you up!
Fuck. He doesn't
Jesus.
Respond to my kicks. Let me kick you.
There you go. He got one kick in. Oh,
fuck, that's a gun.
Taking gunfire there.
Do you have to, like, kick the bomb back at him?
No.
Almost all
it's
of the fights...
The hitboxes are just fucking...
Yeah. Almost all the fights, you feel like there's a trick, but there's never a trick. It's usually just you gotta punch him.
Only Superman has a trick.
Yeah, only the Superman has a trick, as far as I know. Oh!
No, we're getting away from that.
That just took out a whole life.
We just learned now that we are not quicker than a speeding bullet or whatever
No.
it is either.
Wow. Wow, this fight's bullshit.
Dude, you can't hit him. This like middle-aged angry manager dude is just beating us.
He's got so many like invincibility frames on these attacks. It's crazy.
You can't be really close to him because you will miss him.
And then this grenade is point blank.
Yeah, fuck you. I'm gonna kick you in. I'm gonna kick you in the throat.
Gavin says the trick is get good, bruh.
Says the guy who can't beat Sifu.
Oh wow, Gavin can't beat Sifu.
No,
still?
He traded it in.
Wow.
Because he couldn't beat it. I pre-ordered it for him.
Gavin.
That's why one of my first solo streams was me that
Sifu,
game.
Yeah.
Just to prove how much of a scrub he is. So he could see the end.
Yeah, I don't know if he's still here, but Siler was a huge fan of Sifu as well. We both played through that.
Oh, shit, one more hit.
And we both got stuck in the same damn spot.
Which
the,
one?
The museum boss.
That's where Gavin got stuck.
Yeah.
The museum boss.
We beat her eventually, but she was way harder than the other bosses.
Dude, yes, yes. And her second form is bullshit.
So, it is insane.
But I beaten her on medium, I think.
Okay.
But, yeah.
Got him. Forehead down. And now we are off to...
Whew.
What's our next chapter? Okay, I'm going to the bank. Let's go, idea
man. Oh, yeah, get.
We got.
Yeah.
We got Batman
Well!
Batman
He's doing nothing!
He's
so Batman Well!
God damn it, Batman Well!
Oba kick.
He laughed!
Yes! He laughed. Fucking Batman Well! Oh, yes. That was the best one.
I can't believe
that has been so good.
I can't believe it.
They I was not expecting that, but that was the best.
We are an hour and a half into this game, and they were like, this is where we're going to put the useless assist.
Oh, man. So, I've been thinking, there's got to be four buses.
Okay.
All right, because we have four different types of enemies that said... The ninjas, the aliens.
The aliens, the idea men. We're fighting now.
These guys,
yeah. These are the idea men.
So that's three of them, and there was one more that I can't remember.
I don't remember either. I just realized I don't think the stream saw that. But when you start this game, there is a cast list that goes by, and it goes on.
It takes forever.
It goes on forever, and it shows you literally like every single like character that you're going to see in the game at some point.
So to be fair, I don't think the Tick Show had many actual goon types.
There was usually mostly
the big bad boss guys.
I remember an episode where the Tick goes into like a club that's for superheroes. And then there's like a shitty little like sidekick hut next to it.
I remember that. Arthur's like a little tiki bar or some shit.
And Arthur can only go to this shitty sidekick club. It was so good.
But really, is Arthur the sidekick or is the Tick the sidekick?
That's really the question. It's a real, Don Quixote situation.
Because you know, like. If you ask the Tick, no, Arthur's the main reason here, you know?
True. The Tick will tell you all the time, Arthur's the real star of the show.
Dude, but I like his story and shit, he really did nothing. He just pissed me off, really.
Arthur or the Tick?
Arthur. The Tick can't piss you off.
Okay. That's true. There's no way you can get mad at the Tick.
The Tick, don't go there. Yeah.
that was pretty close.
Fuck.
To be fair, I don't think the Tick Show had many actual goon types. They had a decent amount of rogue.
Rogue gallery.
Yeah. Deflator Bat was the best comedy.
Batman Well.
Batman Well.
I call him Batman Well from the first. The first live
had
action.
A couple different names, yeah.
Yeah.
Smack that guy around.
That was my favorite. Him and Lady Liberty had a thing.
Yes.
Well, American Maid, I believe, in the cartoon was
her
name.
Yes, so it was... I don't remember why they didn't like Lady Liberty, but Fox wanted Lady Liberty to change. And so they turned her into American Maid for the cartoon. I do not remember the full story there.
Probably they thought it was offensive.
Maybe. So I just feel like American Maid is worse.
It's kind of demeaning.
Yeah.
You're America's wait staff.
See, Fox is okay with demeaning women, but
yeah,
you can't demean Lady Liberty's stature.
Yeah, yeah, that's not okay.
Yeah, but she had that thing. I don't get it. Yeah, you know, I don't get it.
Possibly. Yeah. Oh, okay.
You have an Arthur.
I do have an Arthur.
You have four.
Well, we'll make use of them for the next bunch, because these guys, I think, are almost toast. Right? Maybe? Yeah, there we go.
No, you got him. You got him. They're still sleeping, though. There we go.
There we go.
Oh, hi, buddy. Hi. Okay.
Aha! Fuck you. Juked.
I feel like that's not the best way to kill somebody. I'm going to jump off this building.
Well, maybe.
And
maybe.
I'm going to hope.
Maybe they didn't mean to. Maybe it's like a Homelander situation.
Yeah, no shit.
It's like when Homelander talks
down. I am going to hope somebody is down there when my skull.
When his skull collides.
Yeah. Like, our thoughts will become one. No.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, there's a cat. There's a cat behind the TV.
Like, our thoughts have become one for that split second.
There he is. Still there. Just for the minute that the skulls collide.
Oh, yeah. Could you imagine it? It would be like that thing in the movies, like when that happens, like when the impact happens and the background changes and everything's oh, yes. all good. And it's like slow frames and pans and then bam.
Over.
Oh, man.
Oh, boy, Kat. You are.
They had a scene of somebody dropping in a Cocaine Bear.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was so good.
I got to see that. I do got to see Cocaine Bear.
Does the game have Knockout Wonder Woman in it? I can't remember her name for the life.
American Maid.
American Maid.
So
yeah.
American, you can get American Maid as an ally, and she kind of like hangs out.
We already had her.
We had her in the
when I was talking
stage.
About the tick moonwalking.
Yep, yep.
That was Lady Liberty.
Yes.
Or American Maid, whatever.
Depending on the one that you're watching. Mm-hmm. In the comics and the TV show, she was Lady Liberty, and then in the Fox cartoon, she was American Maid.
What was she in the live action? Was she
Lady Liberty? She might not have been Lady Liberty. I don't remember.
I can't remember what she was in the live action. I thought it was Lady Liberty.
Yeah.
Because she had that little thing that little ice cream cone type thing that she would open up. So I thought it was Lady Liberty.
Like
little ice cream cone type thing. What is that? What is, the flame? The torch?
Yeah, the torch.
Captain Liberty.
Then what's Lady Liberty? That's the Statue of Liberty, my dude.
She is Lady Liberty.
The American school system here, people.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
what we do here.
Shit.
Arch Clown says that was the name.
Yeah.
Captain Liberty.
Yeah. It is Captain Liberty, my mistake.
Captain Liberty. One of these days, I should really probably read the Tick comic.
Oh, man.
I know its origin, but I've never actually read it.
It might be in my parents' basement.
Yeah, very might be.
Oh, that's cool.
My mom was a big comic collector.
Yes.
No shit.
There are so many comics in that basement.
Most.
In boxes.
Most of Wonder Woman is in
there. Yeah.
Wow.
I'm sure some of those have to be expensive.
I mean, that would require her to sell them.
Yeah, it's not going to happen, but I mean.
She is like you. She never sells anything.
Yeah, no.
But you just
no.
wait till they die.
Yeah, exactly. That's the trick.
Like, this is going to sound really bad. That's how I got my motorcycle. I had to wait till a grandparent to die. So they couldn't give me shit about...
About the motorcycle.
About the motorcycle, because I would crash. Mm. Fun fact, the people in Australia don't know I've crashed.
Oh.
Nope. Wow. Nope. It's like, my grandparents had called the next day. Oh, and they're like, so how's Adrian? And my parents like... He's good.
He's good. Don't worry about him.
He's upright, you
yeah,
know.
He's
moving around.
He's doing great. Ooh, boy. Well, you know, they don't know how to find the stream, right?
So oh, God, safe. No. God. God, no. So my grandpa's photo on Facebook is the typical old person looking down and the camera going up their nose. That is it.
Chairface Chippendale throws a party. Chapter 6. We're going strong here.
Dude, what are we doing? Continues on the last level.
Yeah, that might happen. But hey, we got a level skip code.
Yeah, but we don't cheat.
Ah!
Oh shit, sorry, Cat. What the fuck?
Yeah, he does that.
Well, I'm sorry.
He'll try to kill you in
water?
The kitchen by getting underfoot. You gotta watch out for that.
He's drinking my water. It's all good.
Oh boy.
Oh goodness.
Yeah, he does that too.
He loves to drink people's water.
Hey man, it's good for humans. Good for Cat.
Fighting through the kitchen here.
Oh man, he was getting ready to shoot you too.
We got a green idea man now.
Oh, that means we're in the last stage, right?
Usually.
Because they're green?
I don't remember if they're always green, but yeah, usually when you see a new color, it means you're getting close.
I mean,
to the,
we've beaten the mini boss.
We did. We beat the forehead. Forehead down.
I feel so bad. At least they could have called him the five head or some shit like that.
No, he's just the forehead.
Just the forehead.
Just the forehead.
His older brother, the five head. The better villain.
They got five brothers.
Hmm.
The one head, the two head, the three head, the forehead.
And the five
head. And five head, yeah. Previously mentioned five head. They appear to only be making salads in here. Is that?
It could be a vegan restaurant.
Yeah, could be.
And that's meat. That's
oh, is that meat?
That's a green cutting board with a cleaver.
You're right. That's a green cutting board. That's not a pile of salad. Looked like a pile of salad.
Like, no, that's clearly salad.
Krillin is a six head.
Krillin is because a six head. Yeah.
Krillin.
The most powerful human.
Yes, hands down.
Hands down.
Hands down.
It's just that he's surrounded by not humans.
Yeah, but because he was surrounded by not humans, that's what made him. That's what lifted him.
That's right.
And I really don't think, like, Krillin didn't get a bad deal. He's super strong. He's got the wife he has.
Yeah, he really, like, compared to the
other
guys,
he batted way out of his league here. All right? Like, think.
100% true.
Think, like, Krillin in today's standards.
Uh-huh.
Short.
Yeah.
Done. Like, you know?
Short, done.
Done.
That's it. It's over.
Because he looks. There's Captain Liberty.
This is American made. Yeah.
Lady. Yeah.
Oh, that guy just fucking shot me.
But, yeah, like, the dude can't be more than 4 foot.
Yes.
He can't be.
It's a good point.
Online dating has proven anything. That anything under like 6'2", you're too short.
It's too late. It's just all over. No, Krillin is fantastic. Have you seen a lot of Dragon Ball? Well, I was gonna say Super, but really anything.
No. So Z, I watched a lot of Z when it was on Toonami.
Okay.
But then stopped after the freeze. I watched the start of the Trunks.
Oh yeah.
Saga.
Yeah. Shit gets wild out around there.
Yeah, and I want to continue watching, but I just don't
it's
have
a lot. It's
I don't
lot.
Have time.
It's a lot of time.
And it's always the same thing.
Yeah.
Goku dies. Goku comes back. Goku gets strong. He saves the day. Goku dies. Goku it's the same shit.
That's true. The reason I ask is only because in Super, Krillin is just kind of like, you know what? Nah, I'm done with this shit. He just becomes like a patrol cop. But because of all his training, he's the best patrol cop in the world. Because whenever he's in danger, it never actually feels like danger to him. Because he's like, whatever, I've
got like he's going to get shot.
Yeah, yeah, he's like, I don't care.
Like, he can just fucking Kamehameha someone and it's going to be good.
But yeah, he just kind of like, you know, cruises around, does his like patrol beat and just like kicks the shit out of like random criminals. He's living a great life.
I couldn't imagine Krillin just like giving a criminal a full force punch and just like disintegrating their face. Yeah.
It's like, shit, I gotta hold back.
Yeah, right. Yeah, gonna be the easiest job for Krillin.
Yeah.
Move over a squad car, I can fly.
Yeah, he complains about that in the show, because he has to drive it to kind of like keep his power in check.
Yeah.
But like he could get everywhere faster if he just like jumped in the air and flew there. But he can't do that, because it'd reveal, you know, that he's like got all these secret powers.
Gavin, so the police don't know that
know that he's superpowered, no.
Dude, that is, that's impressive. He could destroy it.
Because throughout the whole Dragon Ball Z series, even though his group is always saving the day, Mr. Hercule is the one who's always getting all the credit.
Yes.
And so the world still doesn't know that all these people are like super powered and super strong. They just think Mr. Hercule has been saving the day all the time.
I used to have a little keyring of Hercule.
Yeah, okay,
oh,
excellent.
Dude, yes, he was my favorite.
So in, are you aware of what his name was in Japanese?
It was Mr. Satan.
Mr. Satan. And,
yeah.
His daughter's name was?
Don't know.
Videl.
Okay.
If you rearrange Videl's letters, you get Devil.
That's amazing. So yeah, because I had a little Mr. Satan thing, you know, that I bought it on eBay back in like 99 or some shit like that.
Good old Mr. Hercule.
False Goku doesn't save the day in the Cell Saga.
It's true, he doesn't. He does not save the day in the Cell Saga. But he sets the stage for Gohan to save the day.
who honestly is just a little bitch. His potential is so much.
Yes. Yes. Oh, shit, I died.
But it would have been better if, you know, he had a dad that raised him instead of some green alien type dude who was an asshole.
Piccolo did the real work.
Yeah. Goku may be a father, but he's not a dad, okay? You know?
Yeah, it's true.
Jesus.
Yeah, in fact, there's a second kid, Goten.
Yeah.
Goten does not meet his dad until he's like 7. Because Goku's dead from, like, his entire childhood.
God.
Good stuff. Good old Dragon Ball. Gotta love.
So fucked up. Classic Dragon Ball games. Yeah, Gohan would have been better if he didn't have daddy issues. I fucking swear.
Not
in Cell Saga, he's not a little bitch. Yeah, no, you can't. Anything you say, Gavin, is never gonna change my mind. All right, not one bit.
So I mostly watched Dragon Ball Kai, which was the version of Dragon Ball that cuts out a lot of like superfluous episodes and things.
Yeah, yeah.
I am told that I missed one really good moment in the original Dragon Ball, though, that got cut, where Piccolo goes to get a driver's license.
Gavin told me about this one. I want to watch that one. Yeah.
So that one is apparently only in the original Dragon Ball Z. They cut that whole sequence out for Kai. Because Kai is supposed to kind of try to solve the pacing issues of Dragon Ball. And it does have pacing issues.
Even Kai?
Kai not as bad. But the original had a lot of problems. Especially, I know, there's a whole section where, like, Goku is coming back from, like, Snake Way, which is, like, the bridge for the afterlife. He runs on that bridge forever in the original series. Like, it is like 50 episodes of him running on that bridge.
Jesus.
It's a lot.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Gavin says it's the best, the car.
The car. Yeah. Oh my God, is this stage still going on? How long is this fucking kitchen?
About the same length of the Dragon Road, my dude.
This fucking restaurant better have, like, space for 20,000 people with a kitchen this fucking big.
Maybe
they're
running in a circle.
Yeah, maybe it's
well,
just a big circle.
Well, yeah, Pringle World. We've established it's just...
It's the Pringle, yeah.
Or it could be like a fucking Scooby-Doo hallway.
Oh, yeah.
Like, how long is this house?
It's true.
Could you imagine vacuuming this carpet? If they took like 5 minutes running through their hallway, me going slow vacuuming is gonna fucking take forever.
Gavin says once you get past the Frieza saga, the filler episodes get a lot more tolerable.
But they shouldn't have filler episodes.
Yeah, well, that's the problem that Kai solves, is Kai just removes all the filler episodes.
I watched Naruto.
Oh boy, that's deep.
Yeah, so I watched all of the original ones.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Wow, a lot of Naruto.
Yeah.
Okay.
And there was this one bit where they're like, do you remember when this happened?
That happens a lot in anime.
Right.
Yeah.
But they just flashbacked to the previous episode.
The one you like just saw.
I just watched this, my dude. You know?
That's really funny.
And there was 3 or 4 back-to-back episodes of just flashback episodes.
Wow.
And I feel like they got to a point where they flashback to a remember when this and they flashbacked again. Like,
oh no. Oh god.
It was a flashbackception type of deal.
Never do a flashback in a flashback.
I don't think it happened, but it felt like it happened.
Yeah. Ooh, man.
Oh dude, I just couldn't. I ended up skipping. I just skipped.
Yeah.
I skipped them.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I don't want to watch a flashback episode of a fight you just fucking fought.
So,
you know?
So Adrian, I don't know if you know this about me. It may have been obvious by now.
You're a weeb.
Bit of a weeb, yeah.
Yeah, I know this.
I couldn't get through Naruto. I couldn't do it.
I did it.
I'm amazed.
I was at work.
Okay.
So it was either customers or...
or Naruto.
Yeah, so lesser of two evils here.
Yeah, Naruto won in the end.
But
man.
Well, I mean, back before lag, I used to watch a fuck ton of anime.
Okay.
So, you know, that was, you know, during my weeb times.
Sure. The weeb times.
The weeb times, yeah.
The weeb
you
era.
Know?
It's amazing that I graduated Weeb and went into video games. Like, I don't know if that's a great... I don't know who's winning here.
I don't either. So what was it? Let me try and guess some of the shows that you watched during your Weeb, your peak Weeb time.
Do it.
Yu Yu Hakusho.
No.
Wow. Okay. Inuyasha?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we got one.
Never finished it, though.
Okay.
There's a lot of episodes.
Who did finish Inuyasha? Inuyasha's a lot. There's a sequel series now.
Yes.
I have watched the first season of it, and then it's...
Oh, you watched the whole first season?
I did. I got decently far.
It was my ex's favorite.
Okay, what were some of the other shows you remember from that time?
Well, FLCL.
Oh, man, Fully that's Cooley. Fucking good.
Oh my God, yes.
That's so good.
I watched that. I watched Bleach.
Okay. Oh, wow, Bleach. That's.
I got to episode 150-something and stopped. That's I kind of want to pick it. Cowboy Bebop.
Yes. I think that's one that I feel I like, did. even people who don't usually watch anime, you can get them.
Outlaw Star?
Oh, Gene Starwind, hell yeah.
Yeah.
And his caster shells.
Yeah, so.
Some good shit.
Outlaw Star.
Fucking love Outlaw Star.
Shit, I did a little bit of Initial D, but not a lot.
Okay.
I watched Akira.
Oh, yeah, that's a classic.
You know, But I watched Akira when I was like 9 in Australia.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, man. Like,
I mean, not in Australia, but I also had
I was too young to watch Akira. And I'm like, man, I don't know what's going on. I'll watch it when I was an adult.
Right.
And then I watch, older teen. And then I watched it. I'm like, I still don't know what's going on. Like, there is so much.
Yeah. I definitely had this experience of, like, going to the store, and Akira was just in, like, the cartoon section. Because the people there didn't really understand the difference between, like, you know, there wasn't really a whole lot of, like, things that were animated just for adults. And so it was just in the cartoon section, and I went and rented it when I was, like, 10.
Oh, man, yeah. My uncle showed it to me.
Great.
Best uncles.
What a guy.
What else did I watch? What is it? Renma One Half?
Ridiculous. Oh yeah, I watched
some
much
of that. Not a lot of that. I couldn't dig that one.
I watched a lot of Renma. That's a.
There's a lot that I remember watching, but don't know the name of.
Yeah, that
know?
Happens. That happens. Did you see any of the follow-ups to Fooly Cooly? Because there's been two additional.
No, I have not.
Okay.
But I want to.
Yeah, I enjoyed. I think it was the third one. I really enjoyed.
I want to watch the first six, because it's like six episodes,
it's
you know?
Breezy, you know?
And
it's breezy.
The soundtrack by The Pillows, it's so good.
Yeah, so fun story. I went and saw The Pillows at the Whiskey A Go-Go in L.A.
Are they good live?
They were very good live, but that's not what I remember about the show.
Full Metal Alchemist,
yep, classic. That's not what I remember about the show. What I remember about the show is some drunk guy jumped up on stage and grabbed the guitarist. And then the guitarist dropped his guitar, beat the shit out of him, and threw him off the stage.
Wow!
That's what I remember about seeing The Pillows.
I've only seen one Japanese band.
Oh my God, it's finally over.
It was called Melt Banana.
Melt Banana.
Melt Banana.
It's
solid. Melt Banana.
Melt Banana. I like
it. And it was funny because they started their set. They're like, we're Melt Banana from Japan, and just went heavy. Because they were opening for Tool.
Oh my God, that's crazy.
So it was great, you know? A lot better live than they are recorded, in my opinion.
He's back, of course.
Kick, maybe he kicks.
No, he doesn't do shit. He doesn't do shit.
He fucks, we know he does.
That's what he does.
That's all he takes one punch and leaves.
Takes one punch and he leaves, that's what he does.
Everyone's thinking he's a hero, but he's terrified.
Okay, so far I see dining space for maybe 40 guests.
And you haven't finished the room yet.
You're right, maybe there's more.
And we don't know where it started, you just appeared in this room.
That's true.
Let's see, so I did watch Full Metal Alchemist.
Full Metal Alchemist, and,
I hated the ending.
It's pretty bad, yeah.
So like, I
never made it to the end.
We watched it, and I remember like when it ended, I stood up, I'm like, Fuck you, TV. This is bullshit. So when they had the movie that kind of finishes up.
Yes, yes.
I was way happier.
So I know Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood, which is the second run of it. I believe the idea was to make it more accurate to the original source material.
Yes.
Because the problem they ran into with the first show is they outpaced the manga. And rather than postpone a new season, they just went.
They went nuts. Yeah.
They went.
So I want to watch Brotherhood. I haven't watched Brotherhood.
I haven't seen Brotherhood either, but I did see the original.
I had the PS2 game.
Ooh.
And I thought it would be really cool because you could go in and like, I want to make this a turkey.
Just go.
You know?
Yeah.
And it's not like that.
What? What do you do?
Well, you go and there's like light poles and shit like that. You can you can do your thing too. And then you know the more you get, the certain things will turn into objects, and then you can enhance them with like fire or lining and shit like that. So there's a little bit of tweaking you can do.
Sure, but you can't just like alchemate things.
Yeah, like you see a rock and you're like, all right, this is now a bazooka. No, you know?
No transmogrifying people into their pets.
Oh my god, why does it hurt? God. So my I had a customer who has a shirt.
Okay.
And it's the dog and the chick doing a fusion.
Oh, that's so fucked up.
And it's got the alchemy circle behind them. Oh my god, it is so fucked the up. Best shirt.
The thing that's great about that shirt is it's the kind of shirt that only the people who have seen it will understand. Everyone else will just be like
he walked in one day wearing that shirt. I'm like, that is the best shirt.
So good.
Because you got this cute, you know, you got this cute dog and a cute little kid just like doing the fusion thing. You know, they're posing, they're touching. Oh, man. It is the best. But yeah, that kind of hit you in the feels in that.
Yeah, it did.
And her dad did it, right?
Yes, it was her dad, yeah.
Whew.
Fucked up stuff.
Yeah, no shit.
Some fucked up stuff in Full Metal Alchemist.
What else did I watch? I don't know. I watched a lot.
Yeah.
I watched a lot.
I mean, getting through.
The baseball bat,
babe. What, the baseball bat? Paranoia Agent.
Yeah. I didn't. Nope.
Yeah, that was good. Boogie Pop Phantom.
What is it?
I could be making stuff up now.
It's something about Vampire Hunter D.
Oh, sure. Yeah, that's a classic. Love that one.
I did Trigun.
Woo!
I did Trigun.
I showed Evie the first episode of Trigun Stampede the other day.
Yes, yeah.
I got mostly very confused looks.
So fucking confused.
It's so good, though. God, now I got to watch all of these with Mrs. Lag.
Yeah, perfect.
Oh, shit. Got to sign up for, like, fucking Crunchyroll or some shit.
Yeah, little Crunchyroll.
It's still Trevor's
password. That's true. God fucking damn it! Motherfucker fucking Batman well! Coming all up in here.
Yeah, but he's just a one-hit shield.
And there he goes.
But I watched way too much shit. Because I was a weeb in high school, so, sure. you have all this time.
It's true.
Evangelion.
Oh, sure, yeah.
I binge-watched that in one day.
Whoo! That's a lot of Evangelion.
Get in the Gundam, Shinji.
You're close. You're close.
I just don't, like...
What does Mrs. Lag like to watch, asks Gavin. I know an answer fits all four of us.
Shitty movies.
Shitty movies, yeah.
Shitty movies. Man, yesterday's double feature was the best.
Double feature of You're the Hunter from the Future and Space Mutiny.
So when I first started dating Mrs. Lag, I went to her house.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't, like, I had never been in, like, I've only been in my friends' houses and shit like that, right?
Sure.
So I went to her house, and in my house I had this hutch unit, and I just put a whole bunch of toys in there. Because that's what you put in, like, I'm not going to put plates and shit, I'm going to put Transformers and sharks.
Yeah.
Or,
The good stuff.
So I walk into her house, and she had a small little hutch unit with Inuyasha figures and toys and shit like that. And I'm like, this dude's awesome, you know?
That's amazing.
Oh, man, it was amazing. So she likes Inuyasha.
Okay.
Mrs. Lag, you're here. What else? What else do you like?
Yeah.
You guys watched Way of the House Husband.
Yes, we did Way of the House Husband.
Yeah, because that
And that should have been my life.
My
favorites.
Man. Big fan of Way of the House Husband. Really enjoy that one.
Like, so he doesn't know how to fight.
I do not know
how to fight. I don't, but we could fight each other until we know how to fight.
Yeah, that's how it works. Nor do I have a dark history
that I left behind.
It's a different kind of dark past. It's a different
kind
of dark
past. I mean, we all have a dark past.
Yeah.
That's true. He can be broody, though. You can get the brooding.
Oh, man. Yeah. Yeah.
Mrs. Lag is thinking. It's processing. Answer loading.
I mean,
Inuyasha is insane. Like, the amount of episodes...
I just can't...
It's good. I mean, so this is the thing, is the creator of Inuyasha, Rumiko Takahashi, is also the creator of Ranma One-Half.
Mm-hmm.
And I just... It blows my mind the way that she creates a show, and then she's like, and I'm going to make this show go for fucking 10 years. This is a decade-long show. And you know what? I'm going to fucking do it again.
So Gavin's like, Mrs. Lag likes to watch books.
She's paid to watch books.
I mean, she did have more books than I did. Yeah. She still does.
Yeah.
Library walls. So she does have the library walls.
Library
walls. Walls. Oh,
walls.
Wars.
Library wars? Wars.
Yeah,
that's
walls.
Is that a show?
No, it's a book.
It's a book. Okay.
Sorry,
okay.
I can't speak.
Wars. Okay.
Wars.
There you go. Yeah. That's good. Okay.
Wars. Oh shit.
So it's a book.
So it's a book. Yeah, we have him.
Okay. Good.
We have him. Like, yeah, she has a lot of book. It's really weird. So when we went on our first date, so it's like she's a librarian. I'm like,
yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Fuck. Like,
what do I do?
What am I gonna, you know? And she mentioned something. I'm like, I've read one book, which was true. And I'm like, Ready Player One.
Okay.
And she's like, oh, fuck. Well, she didn't say that. So. But she's like, oh, fuck. I've read Ready Player One. And then, bam,
good
we
start.
Just.
Good start. Yeah, nice.
Yeah, she didn't get any of the references in that. But it's fine.
There were a lot. There were a lot of them. Yeah.
Well, you know what Mrs. Lag is like.
Yeah.
This is good.
This fucking restaurant, you know, I'll give it to them. I have been proven wrong.
At least
this restaurant does have room for 20,000 people.
At least
it does,
this,
in fact, need a giant kitchen.
At
it
least
does.
This restaurant isn't understaffed. Okay.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, the nose.
Oh, no. Oh, man. The nose.
Is he sneezing
He's
on you?
He's sneezing bullets at me.
No, I don't even think they're bullets. They're just wind.
You think? Because I'm pretty sure he's sneezing bullets. Right? Are those bullets flying at me?
No, I swear that's just nose hairs!
Oh, is he shooting nose hairs? Oh, God, this is awful.
Black little squiggly things.
Yeah, take that kick. That one kick.
Dude, he's just firing them off.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah, here we go. Get a kick. Let's go.
The movie is great because Spawn is a small background character in the movie. What movie?
Oh, no.
Oh, okay, okay. No, the movie sucked balls.
It's not good.
I hated that movie. Like, I've never watched a movie that was from a book that I have read the book.
Okay. Oh, that was your first experience with
that. I understand they can't do everything.
Yeah, yeah.
But...
stealing is not nice.
But, like... they're gonna make it, and then like the very first scene, I'm like, this is not accurate. And I'm glad I didn't watch it at the movies. I watched it on a plane back home.
Okay, okay, that's good.
You know, so I'm glad that I wasted 3 hours on a plane watching a shit movie.
Gavin says, but Spawn.
Okay, yeah. Spawn can't save everything, Gavin.
Yeah, no. You put one background character that's great in a movie, that doesn't make the whole movie great, unfortunately.
I mean, they had Tracer. I liked Overwatch.
Didn't make the movie better.
No.
To say the least, the book...
Sea Urchin, that's him.
Yeah, the book-to-film discussion is definitely one that crops up often. And I think, on average, a film adaptation to a book is usually not great, but sometimes it's done pretty well.
Okay, so I watched a movie later, The Art of Racing in the Rain.
Yeah, 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 I've heard of
that book, that movie, good.
Yeah,
It did well. Like, they changed a few things from the book, which is understandable. I don't know if you've read the book.
I've not read the book yet, no.
And it's understandable why they've done it. Did you watch the movie?
I haven't seen the movie, but my dad saw it and said it was like one of the best movies he's seen, and for him that's unusual because he's not usually much of a one for that type of movie, I guess.
So I got the book from my lawyer.
Amazing.
And while I was suing my business partner, and he's like, "You should read this." I'm like, "All right." Yes. And fuck, it was good. So when they made the movie, I'm like, "Man, yeah, I've watched Ready Player One. Yeah, this is gonna be bullshit." Oh my god, it's so good! Like they did such a good job.
I'll have to check it out.
Fun fact, I also watched that on a plane going to Australia.
Wow, you get a lot of your movie time then on planes.
Dude, you have 14 hours.
That's true. Plenty of time to catch up on movies.
I had seen it beforehand. Right. I think we rented it or some shit, but I'm like, this is a good movie. I'm watching it again.
Yeah, why not?
Like, people started cutting onions on the plane. It was really awkward for a bit, you know?
Yeah, I do need to see that and probably read it.
Read the book, because the book is good. Yeah. I mean, the detail the book goes into.
I made it through Zen and the Art of Motorcycle Maintenance. I can probably.
What's that one?
Oh man, it's an experience. It is. Yeah. So Zen and the Art of Motorcycle Maintenance is all about a former professor who is taking his son on a road trip across the country.
Ooh, I want.
Yes, with some other people. It's like a big like motorcycle road trip.
Yeah, a rally.
The whole trip is also framed around him basically critiquing our entire education system. So as he is driving, he is thinking about all the problems with the way our education system is set up. And the author himself, Robert Persig, was actually he had really bad dissociative disorder to the point where he actually had a split personality.
No shit.
Yes. And so the book is also a little bit autobiographical in that he is
Just drink my water, it's fine.
Buddy.
The book is not. I got it.
The book is also a little autobiographical in that it kind of details his experience and his time where, you know, he would wake up one day and not remember the past week
because
his other personality
his
was
other
in
self,
charge.
Yeah.
Well, and he has a kid, and as a kid, yes. He has had all these experiences with his dad.
Because it was the other person. That
but was the other person a nice person?
No, he was not.
So in real life, his split personality was like a villain.
A little bit.
He was like a more fun.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the way to put it would be he was definitely like erratic is the right word for it. He wasn't necessarily like an asshole, but he was like eccentric and he did all these big crazy things.
So sometimes his kid would have a lot of fun.
With yeah.
Go on some like. Crazy fun like adventure together.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Oh, cool.
I'm sorry, Gavin. So Gavin said didn't. He said didn't. Ready Player One have Transformers in it?
Probably.
Which didn't make.
Does not make it good.
Didn't improve the
movie.
All right,
look, man. I could put a Transformer in shit, and it's still shit. I'm not gonna like shit more because there's a Decepticon chilling in it. All right. It's just the
shit in the form of Megatron is still shit.
Right, exactly, you know?
And Gavin also says, have you guys seen ROTOR? I stand by saying it's the best shit movie.
No, it's not. No, it's not. But yeah.
No. ROTOR. I don't know if I've heard of Rotor. I don't know if I've heard of that one.
I've watched Taya. Taya's pretty. Oh, Rubber. Sorry, Rubber.
Rubber.
Okay,
Rubber.
Good. Rubber's pretty good. Sentient Taya. Fuck yes.
I have not. No, I haven't seen that, Gavin. I don't know what that is. You'll have to fill me in. Do 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 do.
I'm almost dead.
You are. We still have what? Three continues?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. I thought it was like five.
You know, this...
I don't know. We'll find out now.
Yeah, this game puts the beat.
Three.
Three, okay. Dun, 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 dun. Like I said, we're going to get to know the music in this game very well. Yeah, slap that guy around. It's good. Yeah, in terms of books to movies that I have enjoyed, I think one of my favorites is Thank You for Smoking. I think the book was good. I actually think the movie was better.
Okay.
Which is a rare statement, but I stand by it. And then Coraline, I also really enjoyed as an adaptation. That guy died from watching you throw that other dude.
Dude, sometimes fear is the best thing.
Gavin, fill us in on what Rotor is.
Yeah. Maybe we'll do it for a movie night.
Yeah.
A Gavin movie night. What could go wrong? Jesus.
Decap Attack flashbacks.
We watched it the same day we watched Freakazoid.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Oh man.
Just imagining it like an episode of Naruto where, like, Gavin wants to do something and you flash back to Decap Attack.
Listen, I like my customers. I don't think I'm going to be hanging out with them after hours, all right? Unless there's a lot of alcohol to be involved. Like, I do go to the bars a lot with some of my customers.
Yeah, sure. I mean, Poor Brothers is right there.
So I got this really cool Poor Brothers story.
Oh, yeah?
So one of my customers, who's from Texas, and he was in town, and he was waiting on the trade. So I had a customer from Texas waiting on a trade from the Minnesota dude. Okay. It was so fucking weird. All right? So anyway, he's like, I'll be at Poor Brothers.
Okay.
I'm like, all right, cool. So he comes in, and he's like, I don't want to say this, but... Mm-hmm. The bartender wants me to call you a cunt. I'm like, all right, cool. That's what happens. Don't worry. So anyway, so the day goes on, and this old guy comes in, and he wants to pick up an NES in 1942.
Okay.
All right, cool. And I'm like, oh, yeah, let me get that ready for you. And he's like, oh, I'll go across the road to the bar.
Right.
And I'll be back in like 10, 20 minutes. I'm like, oh, that works. Uh-huh. By the way, go up to the bartender, give him a stern look, and say, you fucking cunt. And he just stares at me. I'm like, just do it. He's like, I'm not going to get in trouble. I'm like, no, just do it. And the guy's like, okay. So for the rest of the day, me and Brandon were sending random people to each other's stores, calling him or me a cunt. It was the best day.
Wow.
Yeah.
What a day.
Oh, that's a really long text, Gavin. Jesus.
I got it. It's supposed to be a mixture of RoboCop and Terminator. And he's supposed to be a traffic cop, but the mechanics rush him out too soon, and he starts killing people for speeding and shit.
Oh, shit, I would watch that.
That's pretty good. What is his weakness? I'm supposed to guess what his weakness is. If they rushed him out too early, I mean, I would guess he would have a lot of weaknesses.
Red lights.
Red lights.
Like the color red.
All right, Gavin, our first guess is red lights.
Like the color red. Yeah.
That's the color red in general.
Yeah, so blood. He doesn't like blood.
That would be a real problem if you're going out killing
people. Yeah, but he's going to kill people anyway. Yeah. And then he breaks down every time he kills somebody, and then they have to go clean it up.
It reminds me of, there's a Spider-Man villain, Carnage.
Fucking love Carnage, yes.
Carnage is great. There is a
Car Horns,
he's a traffic cop. Jesus Christ.
Ha-ha!
We got a real guest here. There is a comic series where Carnage sees Venom and Spider-Man, like, doing all this stuff and being respected and everything. And Carnage is like, you know what? I'm going to try and go straight.
Oh, yes.
I'll try to be a good guy. And then he sees someone, like, park in the handicapped spot without a permit, and he just grabs the car and crushes them while they're inside.
Yes. And this is why we like Venom.
Yeah.
Jesus. Yeah.
Justice by Carnage.
Carnage, yeah. Carnage is great. That's why we like Carnage.
That's why we like Carnage. I really enjoyed the Maximum Carnage game on the SNES.
We also got that.
Oh, do you? Mm-hmm. There you go. Look at this. All these beat-em-ups you got in now. Although, Maximum Carnage, I think you may have had before that, even.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, but yes.
Okay.
We've got that. Yeah, we got a bunch.
Yeah.
A bunch of games.
Good old Maximum Carnage. Much better than its
Sega. You
want
to play DuckTales 2? We got it.
Excellent. Maximum Carnage, much better than its Sega Genesis counterpart, Separation Anxiety.
Also got that.
Oh, wow. Look at this. I'm just naming all these things. Free advertising. Well, I guess the whole point of the stream is advertising.
Kinda. It was really just to get me to play video games.
But yeah, I mean, I remember as a kid playing through Maximum Carnage and being like, that fucking ruled. And then I found out about Separation Anxiety and I got it, and it's not the same. It's not as good.
I hate it when that happens.
Yeah, real bummer.
Well, like when you go see a movie that you're like super excited to see, and all the good parts were just in the previews.
The fucking trailer? Yeah. That's the worst.
So I kind of like Transformers, yeah?
Yeah, sure.
And when they were doing Grimlock in whatever Transformer, I was getting so fucking excited. Fuck, the guy's on my arm for fuck's sake, you know? Like, this is how much I like the dude.
Yeah.
And I remember it was like, I was 2 hours in the movie, and I'm like, I want to go home.
Grimlock did not.
This is boring. Well, that's the thing. Grimlock hadn't come out yet.
You were an hour into it.
Oh, we were like 2 hours into it. I was so fucking rock.
Rock, take it.
There we go. Yes, like my D&D character all over again. I missed, but it's all right.
It's fine. It's fine. Guy the bug. Guy Elbug.
Leebug.
Leebug. Guy
Leebug.
Yeah,
he was French.
I'm right, French. Guy Leebug.
Guy Leebug.
Guy Leebug. I distinctly remember, this was a long time ago, but at a rap party for one of the theater shows I worked on.
Okay, yeah, okay.
There was
I'm glad
there.
You said theater shows. Yeah. I'm like, man, he went to a rap party?
Not
Trevor's
a special,
fucking hardcore.
Not a special rap party, right? This was like community theater rap party.
No,
okay,
so I'm just thinking like you and a bunch of people that sing rap music and shit.
Oh, no.
I'm
no.
like, fuck,
it's a
Trevor's
party,
hard.
Party that happens after a show ends.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But so one of the people there had Call of Cthulhu. And they were like, we're going to do a one-night, one-shot of Call of Cthulhu. And you had to roll your stats. I don't know if you've ever had to roll your stats for a D&D game
yes.
before. Yes. Okay.
Yes.
I dreadful experience. My character was worthless. I think all of my stats were like under 10, so I couldn't do anything. I was completely dog shit. Like, my character had like a -3 modifier to everything.
So I wanted to make a character and just call him Joe. And Joe just got caught up in shit. Joe's
okay.
nothing. Joe's nothing.
This story is going places. You're going to appreciate that. Because one of our people that was there, Mark was his name. He doesn't have any experience with D&D. He's never done it before. And they were like, you got to pick like a class or a character. And he was like, I want my guy to be a florist. And they were like, okay, I guess you can be a florist. He rolls his stats, incredible stats, through the roof. And so everyone's in there, and everyone was like, I want to be a paranormal investigator, I want to be like a gunslinger, I want to be... And then the florist was our strongest character by far. And so Larry the florist was just running around, just like punching eldritch demons to death with his bare hands, and like breaking down walls for us. And the rest of us were just walking behind him. And I don't think Mark played another D&D anything ever again, but for one night... He was the star of the show. Larry,
that's amazing.
Larry the Florist. Exactly
see,
what
see,
you wanted.
Yeah. So I want to be like, I just want to be, I want to roll a shit character and be like, all right, my name's Frank. My wife just divorced me. I met you at the bar. You seem cool. I'm hanging out with you.
Yeah. I got, you know? No, I got literally nowhere
else to be. I got nowhere
else to be.
We didn't have any kids. I just got fired. Bros, you seem cool. I'm hanging. Yeah. I'm coming along.
Where are we going?
What you know, like, what stats do you want? I mean, I worked in a bakery. I don't know. You know? And, you know, just have him useless. Completely useless.
Yeah,
but he tries.
He does his best. He
you know, his
best.
Pals were with him all along. But they were just shit.
He just needed to find the respect within himself.
Right. So, you know, you go up to the big boss man. He's going to just one-shot him. But, you know. Oh, dude, that looks dangerous. Are we going to step in it? Are we going to step in it?
We've got to step in it, I think. We've come this far.
Yes!
Arthur!
And then Arthur comes out.
Arthur saves the day.
It was a free Arthur, though, right?
Hopefully.
That was half of my health.
Yeah, that was... I don't know if it was worth the cost.
Oh, it totally was worth the cost.
Gavin says, I need you to get the Punisher game on Genesis.
One, that's expensive. Two, I've had it a few times.
You never bought it?
You never bought it.
I didn't know the Punisher game on Genesis was that expensive.
Yes.
Wow. I mean, I remember played that one as a kid, but I didn't realize it was that big. Gavin also says Trevor was busting out those sick bars.
Yes, at your rap battle.
Back from the rap party, yeah.
The rap battle that Trevor was in.
Yeah. Good old
the Trevor
old
that had
battles.
A scar and really bad ass.
Trevor does have a scar.
I do have a scar, it's true.
A very big one.
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, you're never going to see it because it's in a...
Wow.
I have one of those too, so don't worry.
Okay, yeah, see, exactly. He gets it.
I do get it.
But yeah, I fell down. I was climbing a cliff in some place.
Oh, I think that's a bear!
What the fuck?
I thought I was just going to punch it.
What the fuck? Why do you have a bear?
Oh, you're going to get bear!
Oh, God.
This game just has gotten so much better. That was Cocaine Bear, by the way.
The Cocaine Bear was so coked out, he didn't even wake up.
No, we killed him. One shot.
Oh,
one shot of the Cocaine Bear.
What the fuck just happened?
Oh, my God.
That was crazy.
This game has gotten better. Out of the 9 stars I was going to give it, now we're at 10.
Now we're at 10. All I needed was Cocaine Bear to really excel.
Dude.
Oh my god.
This level's been the best level so far. Oh, look at this trap. Yeah. Oh, the trap was for the bear!
It was for the bear.
There was a reason all along.
There was.
Oh
there
my
was
god. Yeah, and this is how I want my character for D&D. At the end, I'm going to do something, and everybody's like, yeah. That's why we took you with us, you know?
Yeah. You know, honestly,
we've revived you 90 times. You've eaten all of our food. We can't heal ourselves. The healer just focuses on you now. But, bro.
That's good. As someone who has been a DM for many a game, I always appreciate the people that come up with, like, creative characters. Because, like, a lot of people who play D&D are like, I don't really care about my background. I just want to make a big, strong dude who hits stuff really well. And it's like...
Oh, that's why I made Guy. Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, there's fun to be had
there. Well, he runs.
There.
He fucking runs.
There's fun to be had there, but there's a lot more fun for me as a DM if they come to me and they have this, like, comprehensive story or background that's, like, creative or funny.
I don't know. Like, yeah. I created one. And,
okay.
And me and a guy... We're going to have intertwining backgrounds because
okay.
we would hang out together. Yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
And so we had all this whole idea, and we'll get in okays from the DM only for him to change it at the very end.
Oh,
and our
sucks.
Stories did not sync anymore.
That's a bummer. That's
so
that's
like
just bad DMing, right?
No,
there.
But he was he's such a good DM, though.
Okay.
We like to joke that his mom is a door because his door sounds are on fucking point.
Okay, that's good. Well, if his door sounds are all right, he can't be that bad.
He's actually a really fucking
but
good
also
DM.
Just I don't. Changing the backgrounds is a bummer, though. I think that's a bummer.
Like, every time we're like, we're going to do this, and it kept on changing. And we were planning this campaign for, like, 6 months.
Oh, my God.
So, before,
that's
like...
planning.
Well, it was before, you know, Session Zero started. We
sure.
had all, you know, we knew what we were going to do.
Right.
We were going to do it. It was... We were in anticipation, because I joined halfway through a campaign. And he was nice enough to let me join at level fucking like 13.
Yeah. I mean, that makes sense because it gets you caught up to where they are.
Yeah.
And then two, it means that he can continue to throw big enemies at
right.
them.
Right. So I joined in their old campaign at level 13 and
right.
he let me do a full on fucking murder hobo.
The old murder hobo build.
I was their DPS. It was amazing.
That's great.
I was just a murder crow basically.
Oh, that's good.
You know, I was just an assassin.
Yeah.
I was an assassin rogue, you know? And I was just It was glorious. Nobody could see me, and I could just slice you in half.
That's
you know?
Pretty good. Were
and
you a rogue?
I was a rogue. I was a Kenku rogue.
Okay. What is...
He's got a bazooka?
He does have a bazooka. Gavin says, this is back when the bear happened. It reminds me of Undercover Cop, where you can slap people with a fish.
Yeah.
It's true. It's a good game. I like that one. And then Arsh is back and is surprised we're still going. We are in.
We're good. Oh, Forehead is back.
Forehead's back. What
Why am
fuck?
I beating Forehead again?
Forehead. Whoa! You fucking sent him.
Yeah.
Jesus. Yeah, Forehead's back for more. Yeah, so I think we're on stage 8, Arch, I want to say. I don't know anymore. Honestly, I've lost track. We'll find out after this.
The tick has lost track.
Tick has lost track. I was told this game takes 3 hours to beat, and we are approaching our
yeah,
three
but three hours.
Hours
with good people, my dude.
I feel like we could possibly be going any faster than we are.
Well, we could not miss a lot of our attacks.
I guess that could be.
And the thing is, like, we're not exactly, like, on him, like, stink on shit right now. So, you know.
Oh, my God. Arch has said something so fucking true. He says that this looks like Leisure Suit Larry.
Oh my God! Yes.
And he turned to crime.
God.
And it's so true.
He's angry. They didn't have that peppermint condom from the first one. He went to that convenience store. It wasn't there. He got angry. He robbed it. Started his life of crime.
Oh my God. Oh Jesus. It's true. It's so true. It is 100% accurate. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, the music doesn't even change for the boss fights.
No.
It's the same music for even this part.
Come on, dude. You're getting kicked by the fucking tick. Just go with the fuck down, Fivehead.
Gavin says the speed run is
23 minutes.
How is that possible?
Oh shit!
How is that even possible? Is there like, some sort of like sick combo that I don't
did,
know?
Did they start off at level last or whatever? Level last.
Level last. The old
oh,
level last.
Man. How is the speed run 23 minutes?
Destiny is a cruel mistress, Arthur.
It is.
It really is.
Oh my god, how?
I don't know. We're definitely going to look that up after this.
Ark is like, well, I'm amazed it takes that long. Well, you're in a cave now. But I'm how? Like, they have to throttle the enemies.
I don't know. Here we go.
Unless there's a fucking glitch somewhere.
How are we? Yeah, that would be my guess. The speedrun is probably full of, like, it's probably full of ways that you can, like, get out of the playfield and then just, like, walk to the end.
So I played a lot of Commander Keen growing up.
Yeah, I remember Commander Keen. Yeah, he's having a time.
And, oh, hi, buds. And the when they get to the more 3D-esque uh-huh. Commander Keens,
yeah.
The way you finish a level is you just have to go past a certain point.
Yes.
All right? So they figured it out that if you get hit,
uh-huh.
pause or save and load, and then when you bump off the screen when you die, it crosses the threshold.
That's great.
And you're done.
That's great.
So, you know.
There's a game.
Oh, you just got bazooka'd.
There is a Hobbit game on PC, and the way that they designed the game is you beat the level. They basically put the end of level gate in a box around the stage.
Okay.
And so then there would be one spot that you could get to where you could pass that threshold. But it means that what speedrunners figured out is if you just got very high or very low on the stage somehow, you can hit the gate and just end the level.
Oh my god. So they're clipping through.
Yeah. So the speedrunning is a race to figure out, like, oh, how can I get up this mountain? How can I get down in this lake far enough that I hit the gate? And so you watch a speedrun, it's just Bilbo, like, jumping into a lake and swimming straight down, and then the level just ends. Or, like, they run towards a mountain and then, like, glitch up the mountain and then the level just ends.
I am so impressed with the speedrun community.
It's really fun.
Finding, like,
weird ways
shit.
To, yeah. It's great. I really enjoy watching SGDQ every year.
Like, I've never found, like, anything breaking in a game. Like, I find these little things every
right,
now and then by
right.
accident, like...
Sure, yeah.
Like, when I was a kid, I had Home Alone Lost in New York on the NES.
Oh, boy, okay.
And the very first boss, if you charge at him and do your slide attack, mm-hmm. right at... If he's right at the end and you hit him, your slide doesn't end.
You just keep going.
And you're just... No, but you're just there. So you're sliding okay. into nothing.
Okay.
But he's getting hit. So he gets hit... He's like animation where he's invincible, but he can't go back because you're right
you're sliding into
you're
him.
Right into him. So, yeah. But you're not moving, and you just stay in there. So he's vulnerability
wow.
and he gets hit again,
wow.
and it's the easiest fucking boss.
It's like the old pausing a bunch when you shoot a boss in Mega Man. Oh shit!
I don't know that one.
It's I don't remember exactly which Mega Mans you could do this. I would assume the really early ones. But you could shoot a boss, and then you would pause the game rapidly, and every time you unpause, it would register as another hit.
Oh, that's brilliant.
And so you could just do that to, like breeze your way through some of the bosses.
That's brilliant. Why is there a sewer in a cave?
I don't know.
And did it kill you?
It killed me.
Sea urchin.
Listen, I wasn't expecting a sewer in a cave.
No, but when I point it out, you must stand on it. You're like a cat in a box. Am I going to sit on this?
It's true. Differently colored grounds. I can't wait. Yeah, no, there's a sewer in this cave right there. One would ask, what is this
could
doing?
Could you imagine city planning? Like, what the fuck?
One must ask why it was necessary.
Batman meets Ninja Turtles actually a real thing.
Is it like a comic? Is it a game? Is it a...
I mean, there was the Transformers that met the G.I. Joes and
that.
Spider-Man.
I remember that.
So, I mean, I wouldn't put it past, you know,
yeah,
Turtles
yeah.
and Batman.
That's true.
Both, like, animal-themed...
It works.
Super thingies.
Yeah, yeah.
Animated movie.
Interesting. I know you got that, in the story, you have that Genesis cartridge that's like Streets of Rage, but with the Ninja Turtles.
Oh, yeah, the hacked cartridge.
Yeah,
I also have Kirby Sonic.
Kirby Sonic. classic meetup.
But there is a game that we should play that's in there
day.
It's Master System Melee or something. It's like a Smash Brothers clone for the Genesis.
Okay. Oh my God.
I've never played it because I've never actually had controllers hooked up to it, and it has no preview, no nothing.
So you have no idea what it is.
I have zero idea. I bought it in a lot.
Thank God.
Yeah, I bought it in a lot. Like when I bought one of my huge lots, it was just included.
Yeah, we definitely gotta see that because I've never heard of that.
Do you own a Genesis?
I do own a Genesis.
Okay, that's nice.
And I have a lot more games for the Genesis than I do this SNES.
He has one.
I have one. I have a single
potentially two.
Game. Potentially two.
So this game,
we're breaking the rules.
Well, no, we're not.
We're not. It's true.
Because so this game's available at the store. Unfortunately, I'm selling it to Trevor as soon as we're done. But
you know, it's I have fond childhood memories of the Tick on SNES, and
so it breaks no rules. It came in as a trade.
It did, and
it's available at the store.
Yeah.
Yes, it was always hidden.
I'm sure I'm not the first person to buy something as soon as it's come in and been available for purchase.
No, my fucking Trevor. my quickest flip.
Uh-huh.
So I've got two quick flip stories.
Okay.
My quickest flip is I was buying a Game Boy Advance SP from a guy, and so I give him the money, and there was a line at the register. It was him and someone else, and the person behind is like, "I'll buy that SP."
Okay.
Like I just fucking traded it in from the dude in front of him.
In front of you.
And he saw me test it and everything, and he walks up. He's like, "I'll take
buy
that
it.
SP."
I'll take it. That's really funny.
And I go, "Cool. That's the quickest fucking flip ever." And my second one was
that's amazing.
Oh, dude, it was dumbfounding. And my second one was when I had gone to my new point of sale system, we have the alert system. That was not you.
Gavin says
that was
me.
Not you. I don't believe it was you.
You think you would remember if it was Gavin?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, that was not you.
This was
in like 2012, and Gavin was still hanging out in the store with his dad.
Ah,
all right, so it was not you, Gavin.
Okay.
And then the other time was, so we had the new point of sale system, and we've got the wish list. So a game comes in. Oh, the Pearl Blue SP was, no, but that had been in the store for at least a day before you got to it.
So he bought something quickly.
He bought something really quick.
Yeah.
But it wasn't.
But it wasn't this incident.
No, well, see, the thing is, I didn't sell it to him when it came in because I still had to do my tests to it. And
it
didn't come in with charges. So, you know, there was that question of like, does it actually hold a charge after I charge them?
That's important, yeah.
So, you know. But it wasn't like a quick instant.
Yeah.
You know? But so we had this dude had a wish list and he put Rule of Rose on his wish list.
Okay, yep.
And then he gets pinged. All right? So he got pinged that we had bought Rule of Rose.
Oh, man.
The dude got to the store so quick, the guy who sold it to me was still inside
there.
The store. And he rolls up. He's like, "Do you still have it?" I'm like, "It's been 5 minutes, dude."
That's amazing.
I still have it. And he didn't even ask how much it was. He's just like, "I'll take it."
Damn. So literally the only thing I know about Rule of Rose is it's expensive.
It is very expensive.
I don't know anything about the game.
Okay, so that soundtrack, the pre-order bonus I posted is $300.
Oh, just the soundtrack?
That pre-order bonus is $300, my dude.
Holy shit.
So last Rule of Rose we sold was $750.
Oh my God.
I'm kind of kicking myself because I had a factory sealed Rule of Rose that I sold a long ass time ago for $350.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, yeah.
So, what is Rule of Rose? Do we know?
It's a horror game.
Okay.
It's a horror game. But thing is, it totes the line with kids.
Gotcha.
To my understanding, like I've never played
it. Kids like dying and in danger.
I believe the masterminds behind it, but there's some kind of like, they like violence to kids, maybe a bit of like, maybe sexy stuff with kids. I don't know.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So that's, maybe. I don't know. I've heard a lot of different things about this game.
It toes the line in multiple ways.
It could tote the line on a lot of things. Yeah. And I haven't played it, so I don't know.
Gotcha.
But the mechanics are clunky. The gameplay is shit. Like, it's not a good game.
So people like owning it for the novelty of having one of the few games.
It's Rule of Rose. Yeah. It got banned fucking almost everywhere.
Yeah.
That's, you know?
That's why it's special. Is 'cause
yes.
It's got a unique history.
Eternal Darkness also doesn't last fucking 5 minutes either.
Yeah, I bet. I love Eternal Darkness. I own that one.
Dude, there was so many. Yeah, like the wish list function. People put the most craziest shit. And I feel bad because sometimes somebody's like, oh, let me put Super Mario Kart on your list.
Okay.
I'm like, okay, fine, whatever. And then like 2 years later, we haven't had a copy on it. But then somebody's like, yo, bro, put Suikoden 1 and 2 on the list.
Okay.
And I'm like, I'm not going to get Suikoden 1 and 2 on the list, but I'll put it there. Motherfucker, 4 hours later, I got both of them traded in.
I can't believe it.
And I'm like, so he walks in and he just stares at me. I'm like, I don't know. This doesn't happen.
That's amazing.
So like the wish list is just fucking godsend sometimes.
That's so crazy.
Like I'll get random phone calls. You just bought this. I'm like, how do you fucking know?
Who told you?
You hacked into my video cameras, my dude. So it's great. Man. I mean, It is amazing, you know? But a lot of the good games are on wish lists.
Right, right.
So we get a ton of shit that nobody knows that we get because it flips within 20, 30 minutes.
And people get notified and they come and they immediately buy it, yeah.
Right.
I remember at one point you had an N-Gage. That went pretty fast.
That went to a guy in fucking Kankakee.
Wow.
You know?
Okay, a place I only know because it's a train stop.
So yeah, that went to Kankakee, and the dude ended up buying it, didn't like it, and flipped it for more than what I sold it to him for.
Wow. Damn. Oh, thank God.
Oh, man. The levels are getting longer.
But
just because
they really could be getting shorter. I wish they were getting shorter.
Oh, we're on a different planet. We gotta get to the aliens now.
Okay, yeah, I think you're right.
Can you just run past everything? Is that how you speed run this?
I can't go for it anymore. Am I in fucking Toontown? What's going on here? I can't go past that area. Arthur, let's go, buddy. Yeah, I still can't go up past there. I bet there's more than
I was about to say, if you can just power run through the whole fucking thing.
If only.
Now you've broken the game. Oh, there they are.
Okay. But yeah, the game just straight up won't let you advance past that point.
Why would you want that suppository?
I don't know.
What are you talking about, Gavin?
Gavin? What's going on over there, buddy?
Wrong text.
Yeah, Gavin, everything okay over there?
Why wouldn't you want the suppository?
I can think of a few reasons.
Oh, man.
N-Gage, he says, is the suppository he's talking about.
Autocorrect, right? Autocorrect. Uh-huh. Yeah. I mean, I called Mrs. Lag on the N-Gage when I got it. Like, I put my SIM card in there. Still,
I'm calling you on an N-Gage.
I wouldn't believe it. It has to go N-Gage. Sideways.
Yeah. I mean, it's kind of amazing that it works. Rule of Rose. Rule of Rose. Ba, ba,
ba, ba, ba, ba. I mean, the soundtrack's cool. I think they could have done more.
Just a bit. I think maybe that's kind of my feeling on everything in this game. Could have just a little bit more.
Dude, this game would be amazing if it was two-player.
It would be. It would be amazing if it was two-player. I think there could have been less enemies in every stage. Just a little bit.
I'll kill Adrian when he's drinking water, babe. Rule number one.
I'm just lucky it didn't come out of my nose and everywhere.
I'm just saying.
Well, you already agreed to buy it. So you
I did.
Back
well, I'm not. I'm not bagging out. I want the tick. Okay. I want the tick.
Oh yeah, you just knocked him off the edge.
Speed run this shit.
Ramp it. Oh, nice. Good to the face.
Let's go, buddy.
I really thought like there would be more like. I don't know why I would think the tick game would have more like meats and berries to it, like more substance, but it doesn't.
It really doesn't, no.
And that's like the perfect Adrian game, though. Yeah,
Yeah, it's kind of Toe Jam and
Earl-ish. It is very Toe Jam and Earl.
I've never played Toe Jam and Earl, but
oh,
I can see
good.
It.
I love Toe Jam and Earl. Panic on Funkatron, which I believe is the sequel. My favorite one.
I've got the skateboard. I got a Toe Jam and Earl skateboard in the store.
I gotta, like, double back to make these fuckers appear.
I know.
Please die. Yeah, there we go. Fuck you. What do we think is at the top of this mountain? Is it a mountain? I don't know.
I would laugh that you couldn't jump over because it's there's a barrier.
Like an invisible barrier. Yeah. Fuck you, Idea Men. Please die.
Oh, nice. I still don't see how 20-something minutes, 23 minutes.
I don't know how it's possible.
It's just not.
Right now, I don't even know how 3 hours is possible.
You were so confident earlier today.
I was so sure we could beat the tick in one night. And now I'm not sure.
I haven't really been stuck on levels very much.
No.
We're going. We're competent today.
We can handle a beat-em-up. That's our speed.
Can we?
Yeah.
So
technically,
so
not a game over so far.
Yeah, but we upped our amount of continues we had.
Shh. God damn it, Adrian, we're going to talk about that.
Sucks to suck. Don't believe me. It's been my whole life ripping on people. What do you think's going to happen?
I know. Fuck this guy.
Yeah. Get
fucking out of here.
Jesus, where are you going?
I cannot believe this is still going.
Where are you going?
I'm just going in circles here.
This, what's flying? What is flying? What has been glitched? Get Arthur in here. You're useless, Arthur. Fuck.
Is there like a guy above me that I can't get to? Is that what's going on? Is he, like, on this platform up here, but I can't go up here because of the barrier? Is that what's happening?
Oh, my God. No, Ebi, you shouldn't have said something.
Oh, no, what happened?
We're stuck.
I think there's an
enemy. Go down to the very bottom.
Okay, yeah, we'll go down to the bottom. But, yeah, I'm pretty sure there's an enemy that's, like, glitched, like, above me or something here. I cannot. I mean, I can jump off the edge and die.
No, you can't.
Can you punch that?
Oh, you're right. I can't. Oh! I guess
but
I
then
can.
You continue right here.
Oh, yeah. I shouldn't have done that. Well, I'm pretty sure if I don't continue, we go back to the start and we have to do the levels.
Oh,
I can't go.
Fuck.
I can't go down
fuck.
Either. There's
fuck.
There's an invisible wall there, too.
Fuck! No!
Arthur, kill it.
No! We tried.
Arthur. We've summoned Arthur three
fuck.
Times.
Fuck!
Rubber
fuck!
It is. Arthur can't
who said you have said something?
It was you this time.
Holy shit!
Okay.
Well, it's a good thing you have level codes.
No.
I don't know what else we can do.
No.
I know. We were not gonna have to rely on cheats, but here we are.
Cheaters.
We can't.
Maybe it's the guy who threw off the ledge.
No. I don't think so.
No.
All I know is this is disaster.
What the fuck? What the fuck? We couldn't have this one win.
Nope.
We couldn't have this fucking one win here.
So I'm going to go ahead and...
fucking visible guy right fucking here.
Yep. You enjoy messing around with that?
I will. I will get him. I will beat this invisible guy.
Okay. If an enemy is defeated at the very top or bottom of the screen, they may get stuck in their falling animation. They're dead, but not dead enough for the game to send the next lot of enemies, which traps you on the screen indefinitely.
Wow.
It happens rarely.
Rarely?
My ass!
I mean, it happened once tonight.
But we played this game once.
The only advice they have for us is to use the level skip. That's it.
Only Game Genie can beat him. Oh my god.
Well, fortunately, we don't have to use Game Genie. Are you ready to skip some stages?
Yes.
first thing we need to do.
Ah, that's a good pause right there.
Oh, that is good.
That is a great pause.
I made some mistakes.
Why couldn't you ask me to reset it?
Because I'm dumb.
We've got that on video.
That's all I got. That's all I got.
Are you shitting me?
I know. I can't believe it either.
I'm so disappointed.
It was a bummer, but we gotta work with what we get.
Well, 20 minutes away.
I know. Okay, here we go. Time to level skip.
It's like when you're like really hungry and you get your food and you're like, I'm about to eat, and then you drop it on the floor.
This really is the worst feeling.
God, I had one of those times.
Here we go.
We should change all that, yeah.
Well, so the part of the code is actually setting these to the correct things.
Oh.
So we got to set lives to 7, continues to 4, so that 4. Arthur to 2.
Mm.
Okay, and then we got to go up here and find teleport.
Wow. Level skip is teleport.
Yep.
Who would have thought?
Then we press start.
Oh, man, it's just telling us that we're cheating.
Cheat. That's so good. You were about to tell a story about dropping food.
Yeah, no, well, so I had my girlfriend at the time. She was studying for finals.
Okay. So this is going to happen a lot. Continue. This is how the level skip works.
So is this the 23 minutes?
The 23 minutes speedrun is just
speed run.
Over and over.
So, yeah. So she was studying for finals, and it's like 2:30 in the morning.
Okay.
And I'm kind of hungry. She was hungry. I'm like, cool, we'll go get Taco Bell. It's open. It's close by. What do you want? So I get her order. I get in the car. I go. I get my order, which was nachos Bel Grande.
Oh, okay.
I can love me some nachos Bel Grande.
Okay.
And I get home. So it's like 2:45, 3 in the morning.
Okay.
And I forgot to say no beans.
Oh, my God.
I got so fucking angry.
Oh, my God.
You motherfuckers, you made this the right way, and I forgot to say something.
It's true. As far as they knew, they had done it all right.
Oh, my God. I got so fucking angry at food. Because I couldn't eat them. I couldn't touch them.
Yeah, beans are they're a no-go for you.
No. Like, why would I want to refry a bean? I don't want to even have a single fry bean, let alone a refry bean.
Oh, my God.
Shit.
Oh, man, I don't remember who it was, but someone brought you a burrito to Poor Brothers at one point, and it was just like, they were trying to be nice, but they brought you a burrito that was full of beans.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I get so angry that I, to the point where I tell people I'm allergic to beans.
Okay.
So they won't put beans.
So they won't do it, yeah.
And I remember I went to a Al Toro. And I'm like, can't eat beans. Yeah. And it was a birthday thing. I'm like, can't eat beans. I'm allergic to it. They're like, okay. So I start eating my burrito.
Oh, no.
And I get to, like, there's like a quarter left. And I'm like, that's bean. I unrolled it. And what happened is they put bean on it. And they're like, oh, fuck, he doesn't like beans. So they scraped it off.
Yep.
But they left some on one side. I got so fucking angry.
You hate to see it.
God.
You hate to see it.
Or like I say, no beans, and they won't put the beans in the burrito, but they'll still put it on the side. Or they won't put it on the side, but they will put it in the burrito. I'm like, I thought I said no beans, and they're like, we just thought on the side. I'm like, no beans, my dude, it means no beans, like you know, none.
They thought
nothing.
Maybe. They thought maybe, just maybe.
It's me and onions. I'll be like, yeah. Onions, I have an allergy, and they'll be like, okay, and it'll come covered in green onions.
That's an onion.
That's an onion.
It's in the name.
It's a scallion. And I'm like, okay, it's also called a green onion, which is an onion. It's the top of the onion, people. Please understand a plant and onion work.
Oh, man. But I also found, like, asking, like, waiters at restaurants, like, I got in the habit of, like, if you were to eat here right now, what would you eat? Mm.
And they're like, oh, I would eat this, but I would modify this with this and this with it. I've had some crazy good meals that way. You know, so you take the risk. Sometimes they're like, oh, order the salmon. I'm like, I'm not right. eating salmon. Oh, you're just skipping that level. Fuck that level.
I didn't mean to do that, but we're going to, you know, advance from there.
I mean, I don't think it would have been any different.
I don't think so either.
Oh, that's awkward. Why are you going the wrong way?
I don't know. I mean, I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to go this way, right?
Right, but it's the opposite.
Fuck! Oh, my God!
Twice! Three times! Three times! How are you... I say this every... Four, five... I say this every time. Six. How are you so bad at games? You've blown every single life on this stage right now.
It's literally the first stage I've actually played since we started cheating.
There was no mini bosses
that was,
either.
You know, it's there's all this stuff in the way.
How?
And
how?
Just,
that's a clip, by
it.
The way. But how?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh my! There's another fucking one of these stages. Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my God. I associate this background and everything with just bad times now.
Oh, I bet.
Okay.
Disappointment. Da 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 da.
Gavin's already clipping it.
Jesus.
It's burning through those lives.
So he's got up to what, seven?
Take him out, Arthur.
He died six times. He had one more life before he died.
Yep.
Died.
Yep.
The permadeath.
Okay, I guess we can't advance. We got one more here somewhere.
If there's a shadow.
Well, if there's a shadow, we can now skip the stage. So that's
but
the
still.
That's the good part. But yeah, no, that was a bummer. We almost did it simple and clean, you know? And here we are.
Yeah.
Here we are.
Oh man, now I want Taco Bell for dinner. Because it's dirty.
It's, yeah, because you're not supposed to.
It's Taco Bell.
You eat it and you know it's bad for you, but I just don't care.
It's fucking bad for you.
It's fucking bad for you.
It is. Ice cream at
night's healthy, though.
Is it?
Studies have shown.
Have they?
That you.
Tell me more about these studies. I'm listening.
That you live a happier life if you have ice cream at night.
Okay. Yeah, I can believe that. Yes. One of them taco meals.
Okay, a taco meal.
Yeah.
One of them taco meals.
One of them taco meals.
there's like a
three taco combo.
I'm gonna
thing.
Have to look online to see what they have.
Okay. Don't worry, I got it from here. I can't
believe I'm just about to search Taco Bell menu.
Taco Bell menu.
This is a no judgment zone, okay?
Yeah. I mean, the people
the second
in chat
search result,
might be,
Taco
but...
Bell menu 2023.
2023, specifically.
That's because the Mexican
pizza came back.
Recently
yeah,
updated.
Fuck yeah, let's
nice.
Do it.
When's recent? December 20th. Recent enough.
What's the drink you want, babe?
Baja Blast.
Thank you.
I knew it. Such a fucking weeb.
Baja Blast is a weeb drink?
You don't know how many customers I have that just go apeshit over that
really?
Shit.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's good to know.
It's not the Sierra Mist.
Yeah.
Slightly
I'm starting to understand that, though, because when I did the bachelor party recently, one of the prizes that I had that was like a gag prize was I got Baja Blast socks. It was like socks with the Baja Blast logo on them. And that was the prize that all the people at the bachelor party wanted more than anything. None of the other joke prizes, but the Baja Blast socks. Everyone wanted them. The Adrian study available at lag217.
The what?
He's talking about the ice cream study. Studies
oh, dude, no, talk yeah. to this lag. She's got like degrees and shit. She knows this.
Hi, Bob. Yes, good headbutt.
Ta-da. Oh my God. Tell me it's not happening again. Okay.
I was
Get off the cliff, buddy.
Don't knock him off the cliff. That's how it starts.
I guess it's unavoidable.
I was like, I don't really know how to avoid it here. And also avoiding it means that this goes on a lot longer.
There you go. I sent you the text. It's the one at the very top.
There they are. Yeah. Da da da.
I mean, I could put a current study thing on the website.
You could add a study to the website all about ice cream. People might wonder why a video game website is talking about ice cream studies, but I mean, that's their problem.
Yeah, I'm not. It's not my fault. believe me. Don't believe me.
Look, that was just where the Scientific Journal felt was best to publish their results.
Yeah, no shit.
There was a night one night where...
No, I could put it on your website. It makes sense there, too.
Yeah, sure.
Just put it on there. People believe everything on there.
Tilting at Pixels. Hot breaking news on ice cream. All
right.
Love you.
I'm going on my Taco Bell adventure.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Da, da, da. Oh, my God. I always think I can just keep going, and I can't. I gotta like double back, go into a pier.
I think there's just it's just glitchy.
Yeah.
Oh man, a
I hit the last second.
Wow, dude, going down with style.
I was gonna say,
holy shit.
He went out fucking clutch.
He have good insurance because he earned it on that one.
These fucking switchbacks.
Gavin said, "Call it the latest scoop."
The latest scoop, Gavin, that was good. That was well done.
There's an ice cream shop in Mahomet on Main Street called The Main Scoop.
It's good. Like it.
So pretty decent,
like,
too.
This looks like the end of the stage, but I bet I have to double back, and yep, there they are. Weird stage.
I like it how the guy accessorized his...
His bazooka?
His bazooka with his zoot suit that he's wearing.
Yeah, he wanted a matching set.
Yeah. So not black, like everything else. No, he already had the red suit. He wants the red bazooka now.
Zoot
custom.
Suit riot.
Custom. Custom zoot suit.
Okay. Come here. Slam you around.
Jesus. Are you sure
I did it?
3 hours for this game?
That's what I heard for time to beat.
How long?
Holy shit, this is still going?
I mean, it's a mountain. Like, how long do you think, like, Everest takes to climb and shit?
2 days, right, I think?
I don't know. Well, I really don't know.
I guess technically not 2 days, because I know you have to acclimate at various camps along the way, so you probably have to...
Oh, that's rough.
You gotta stop. What'd you find?
Oh, no.
Oh, acclimating? Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you can't go too fast up the mountain. So, you gotta stop at, there's like a base camp you have to stop at, and then there's also like a first, like, step camp. And you have to wait like a day or two so that your body can, like, acclimate to the new elevation before
that
you
makes
keep
sense.
Going. Yeah. If you go too fast, you can pass out just from being higher than your body's used to.
Okay, so this is, they've got 4 people polled here.
Oh,
so not the most...
It's the most data we have available.
And this is the Genesis version.
Oh.
Which could be different.
Yeah, that's true. Sometimes that happens.
But it was last updated 5.5 days ago. So
People are still keeping tabs on this.
So
huh?
The average time to beat is 2 hours and 56 minutes. So the median is the same.
Okay.
The rushed is... 2 hours and 38 minutes. In leisurely, it's 3 hours and 14 minutes on average.
So it's close to 3 hours. Approximately 3 hours.
They do not have the Super Nintendo.
So we don't know as far as the SNES one if there is more or less.
No, you're right.
But usually in the SNES one, there was more. If there were 2 different versions of a game, usually the SNES one had more
stuff.
There's
a game called the USB stick found in the grass. The main story takes 28 minutes.
The USB stick found in the grass. I fucking love it.
Oh, man.
That's so good.
I would play this.
Look it up.
It came out 2 years ago.
Gavin says I speedrun Mount Everest.
Yeah, PC game. We polled 9 people. 100% is an hour and 24 minutes. The fastest is 6.
The USB stick found in the grass.
Slowest is 3 hours. That's us.
That is us.
We could slow play this.
Yes. That's us. The long play.
Yeah, no shit.
What do you think a USB stick found in the grass is in terms of like genre?
I don't know. I'm going to assume it's like a puzzle game.
I'm going with horror. I think it's a horror game.
Ooh. Found in the grass. Okay.
I think it's like a horror game where you put the USB stick in and then shit just goes fucking ape shit.
Let's see what Steam says.
Yeah.
About this game, it's a bit difficult to classify the USB stick found in the grass as a game.
Okay.
It is more of a combination of literary work and forensic puzzle. Fuck yeah!
Forensic puzzle?
Puzzle.
Huh. Mm. Yeah. You got it.
If you like a normal lost phone or her story,
then
you'll
story.
Probably like
okay.
Tisfitic.
Okay.
The USB stick found in the grass.
I love it. I did actually like her story. I did play that. Although play is kind of a
strong. Oh, that's eyebrows.
It is. Yes, I'm kicking him in the face now, as best I can. He's shooting the shit out of me with his bazooka or harpoon gun. Rocket launcher? I think it's a rocket launcher.
I think so. I don't know why he's called eyebrows though.
Yeah, I'm not sure either.
Let's see.
Her story was a neat little thing where it's like you're interviewing someone and like asking them questions.
Interesting.
Yeah, and as you're asking questions, you're piecing together like what happened. Ow. Okay. Well, like it's one of those games where it's like that. There's no action element. There's no real like sort of puzzle element. It's all just on you to ask the right questions and figure out what happened. Yeah.
You're given a virtual representation of a USB stick that was found at a scene of a possible crime.
Okay.
And you play a police officer trying to solve a case with very limited information.
Okay, I dig it.
You're not given any tools to do so.
Okay.
But you can use any tool you have on your computer.
You are going to do the hideout.
The USB stick found in the grass is not subjective to any intrinsic limitations on which the game is built, quite the opposite. It is close to the real thing as possible. The USB drive you'll be investigating is indistinguishable from a real one.
Okay.
So the computer thinks that's a real USB stick.
Interesting.
And you have to solve it.
That's pretty clever.
The tools you will be using are real. If something looks like it can be checked, it can be checked. If something can't be checked, it wasn't our intention.
Interesting, okay.
It's simply a result of a built-in technological limitation.
Okay.
Your job is to find what it's all about. If the stick is in any way related to what happened, and if anything happened.
Okay.
Remember, sometimes the journey is more important than the destination.
I like it.
So yeah, you're just given a virtual USB stick and you have to solve something.
Okay.
If something. That's very... very interesting.
It is. So it is now 9:00.
Fuck you. Oh!
Batman
Shit, no, he knocks him back when he lands.
Oh, he does. Okay, but then he just leaves.
And then he leaves because he bitches out.
So I'm going to guess that the time to beat thing is definitely for the Genesis version. Either that or we are just legendarily bad.
I mean, yes. That's what I believe.
Because we are currently on chapter 9.
Out of,
the SNES version has, scrolling down, 16 chapters.
Bullshit, how are you going to do this in 20-something minutes?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, 16 chapters. We got 16 chapters. So it is safe to say we are not going to beat this game tonight unless we just start skipping levels.
Yeah, no, that's, no.
Okay. If you do decide to skip any levels here, you can just hit L and R at the same time to immediately advance to the next stage.
No, I figured we'll just play until Evie gets back with food.
Okay, sounds good. But yeah, I'm going to say the SNES version must be longer than the Genesis.
This has got to be. We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
We'll search and see if there's any differences between them. Because there's no way. 20-something minutes, half an hour to beat this? There's no fucking way. I mean, we suck, but there's no fucking way. Not with the respawn rate of these fuckers.
Yeah, no, it keeps coming. It just keeps coming. And the stages are so long. Oh my god, the two fucking mountain switchbacks went on forever.
Right. And it's not like you can find a quick way to kill things over and over again. Like, what are you going to do when you wait for this shit? Overall, cool game.
Yeah, you know, I feel it's a beat 'em up. It's a classic SNES beat 'em up.
Dude, yeah, I feel like it's... God, we're still not... If you had, like, 10 minutes to play a game and you didn't know what to play, there's no story here. I don't even know a story.
There hasn't been one. The story has been... you got to figure it out from the chapter titles, and that's all you get.
So, like, I like that, you know? He does a really good at bending his fucking knees doing that.
I have just received a message from my dad asking if I am still alive because he has just heard about the tornadoes that touched down yesterday.
Quebec went storm chasing.
He went looking for the tornadoes.
He did. He got a video of one.
Oh wow! Nice. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Way to go, Quebec. Wouldn't be a choice I make, but good for him.
Yeah, you don't seem like the adventurous type, though, man.
You're not wrong. I'll try most things once.
I feel like the most adventurous thing you've done is getting kicked out of a go-kart. Like, even that does not seem believable, but it's happened apparently.
That did happen, yeah.
So, yeah.
I was a rebel, a 9-year-old rebel.
Ah, young Trevor.
Yep. Lost my edge as I got older.
Well, old age does mellow you out.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
I feel like my old age has just made me more and more.
Yeah. I'll put it this way. I can think of some things, but they're not things I'm comfortable talking about while a stream is on.
Oh, no, I understand that completely.
But also, you're not wrong. Like, the type of adventurous things I've been involved with have not been things like storm chasing or bungee jumping or anything like that.
No, I can't bungee jump. I want to skydive, but I can't bungee jump.
Okay, yeah. Skydive? Yeah, I could do that. Could be fun.
I mean, what's going to happen? You're going to die. I'm tethered to somebody.
Yeah. My buddy Shane has been skydiving quite a few times.
My brother used to pack his own chute. He got super intense into it. Yeah. The cool one, not the shitty one.
Not the shitty one. Good to know.
Great. I hope he never watches this. God, that's going to be awkward at dinner. You called me a shitty brother.
That's fine. It'll be fine.
That's fine, yes.
Yeah, don't worry.
You will live, shitty brother. You will live.
Just ask, was I wrong? Dun, 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 dun. We could have had a couple more music tracks. I think that's safe to say.
Right, yeah. I mean, this game leaves a lot.
It does.
But it doesn't need a lot.
It doesn't need a lot. No.
So it's...
For what it was at the time, it was great.
I mean, I feel like it's great now.
Yeah.
It's just...
Yeah.
We expect so much in a game at this point.
We really do. It's true.
You know, so the simplisticness of it is good, but it does get monotonous. It gets repetitive.
It gets very repetitive. There's a lot of similar stuff happening here.
Right.
It probably would have been nice if there was a save function, because this game is real long.
Yeah.
Even for an SNES game.
3 hours.
Three hours, assuming it's the Genesis version. I'm going to assume that if it's SNES, it takes longer.
We'll research that.
Yeah, yeah. But this is definitely the kind of game, like, even when I was a kid, I remember pausing this game whenever we had to go somewhere. Because that was the only way I could, like, kind of save my spot, you know?
But then you could have just cheat to, like, load.
Well, my dumbass. Well, I guess maybe. Eventually, I probably got a tips and tricks that would have told me how to cheat. But I never did with this game. I always played this game straight.
Well, you would think, like, why didn't they have a password function?
That
would have
been that would have been perfect. Yeah,
that would have been perfect.
That
would have
definitely solved
per level.
Yeah. You know, I know a lot about the Tick, but I don't know a lot about the studio that made this game. Let's find out. Let's find out some stuff.
Are they defunct like every other studio
probably,
we look up?
Probably.
Man, you went fast.
Whoa, man, yeah, he's like moonwalking. Oh, you're talking to Evie?
Evie, yeah.
Okay, I thought you were talking about the guy moonwalking past you.
Oh, I know where Taco Bell is. Oh, did we just get somebody else's order?
No, there's no way, because they don't have the big box anymore, so I had to make it.
Oh, I'm sorry, but the menu said it. My bad.
No, it's because they're out of fries.
They
didn't have
fries.
Oh.
Okay. Just substitute it with something else.
Right?
They have fries?
They didn't have... That's what's in the big box.
Oh. Cool, fries. I didn't know you could get fries.
Well, you can't.
Clearly.
Software Creations, now known as Acclaim.
Oh!
There you go.
It's an Acclaim. Okay. Yeah. I'm wrong. They still...
Well, this studio is no longer around, actually. I mean, Acclaim is still around, but this particular studio, which was in Manchester, is no longer around.
Oh, shit.
They made...
Having that up would be... Yeah, there we go.
They made Cutthroat Island. They made Beauty and the Beast. They made Equinox.
So like IP games.
Yeah, they did a lot of that.
All right.
There's a lot going on back there.
Yeah, no shit.
Oh, they made the Silver Surfer game.
For the NES?
On the NES, yeah. The Silver Surfer NES game.
Bobbin has appeared. Yeah.
Bobbin has...
so shiny.
Bobbin's there. They made Double Dragon 3.
Okay, I think, would this be a good place?
This is probably, yeah.
Yeah.
You know what? Hit L and R, skip the stage, and let's see what's next. And then we'll
spin. Wow, great timing for that one. Holy shit.
Okay, I thought so. They made Maximum Carnage.
Ooh.
Which checks out.
Oh, no, another one of these. Alligators.
This is the perfect place.
Level.
This is the perfect place to stop right here. Oh, they made Tin Star. I fucking love Tin Star.
Oh, did I get that recently? I can't remember. Maybe.
Okay.
No swimming. My dude, there is alligators in there. We ain't swimming. We ain't swimming.
Tick's about to be alligator food. Oh, that was it.
That was the whole stage. That was easy.
Wow.
All right, I think that's where we call it.
That is going to be where we call it. Here on Chapter 10, where Chairface
writes... Out of 16, did you see? Fuck, man.
We had six more to go.
There is no way. There was no way.
Six more to go. But, you know, we're going to the moon to fight Chairface.
Oh, man.
Some other time.
Yeah, we haven't even gotten to the fucking aliens.
Nope. All right, I'm activating transitioning.
Do it. See you, fellas.
See you guys later.
Guys and girls. Next week.
Yes, indeed.
We have another riveting game.
I'm sure we will. So long, everybody.